Good evening, ladies. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Ray Lewis. I'm here because I want to clarify some things. I want to come on a platform as large as the Bodega Boys podcast to make you understand one thing. When I fell down to my knees on the field of play in the National Football League, in which I served 38 tours of duty, caught two homies and Euro-stepped them shits, what would make you think that I would disrespect the flag of the United States of America? The flag that helped me beat that body. I thought that we was in church having a service. That's why I dropped down to both my knees. A nigga like me that tithe the way I do, why would you think that I would disrespect my country? And I'm getting emotional just thinking about how I skated on them motherfucking Chargers, and I'm out here in a $5,000 suit talking some bullshit on ESPN. Jason Whitlock, what you got to say about all of this?
It's wing day in the calf, so you want to just wrap this shit up so we could go? Thank you. This is episode 82 of Bodega Boys. I love the taste of honey with butter. To the trap.
Live from Red Bull Studios, New York.
It's always funny when Jason Whitlock catches a stray for no reason.
For no reason.
Just
fuck him.
Mind his business. Fuck him. Jumped his tree in the Fox Sports Arena. Like, oh no. Oh, hot no. Wings. Nigga bend over, mad spaghetti fall out of his pocket. Yes. Yeah. Episode 82.
That's right, you ball bags.
The same number of games. That the same number as the number of games the Knicks is going to win.
That's right.
We're putting it out there in the universe.
Super team, Michael Beasley, we MVP.
We might lose one game on a technicality. Because Michael Beasley brings a burner to the game. Nigga leave it on the seat.
Nigga's going to win MVP, marijuana vaping player. Yo.
Oh, shit. Yo. Coming to you live from 221
18th right.
Street. Red Bull Studios, you know what it is.
Come on, dog.
Drop. It's your boy, D's Nice, aka D's Vice, aka Dung Chipotle.
That's right.
Aka Boxing Fat Interior, aka Chris Tapsworth, Eli Lippy, Boots Blue,
Gully,
Sober Damn, I Know You, Bitch, Young Day Party, Young Hot Take, DJ Fuego, Mr. Nando's, Whatever I Know, Emil Nova, Santana, Vata, Quato, Mikhail Noventa. Oh, yes.
Yes.
Mikhail going off.
It is going off.
It is going off.
Hold your chest.
The tingle skirt. Skirt. The Juve boss, empty little room beat. Put up for 40 with your shorty, aka don't talk to me in the Uber pool.
Doug, I have no fucking idea. You know who I am because you see the billboards. Yes, but right. I don't know who you are.
Guess what? I'm here to get from point A to point B.
That's it.
Not to create a new human relationship.
No.
Got play. Jesus Rothstein, the Jamaican Jew. Happy Rosh Hashanah for those of you who are in the coma.
Happy 58-87.
You know what I'm saying? 57. Jamaican avocado toast. Young. The ghost of Mufasa. Young Chacunuri. Out the Kunuri. A.K. Chili Lamone. Left-handed reliever for the Yankees. Kill. Okay.
Papi, tamo lindo. That was a good night in 86. Remember that?
I remember that. Danny Martin. Great crash. You know, drink.
Yeah.
Three-fold Jones, Jesus, Machina, J. Chuckle, Stanley Cups, the human Dr. Bonner's label, dilute, DNR, J. Trapio, Mr. 240 Peaks, like my Pinot.
Yeah.
Okay, DJ Woolite is listening to Washed FM. Up next, we have 4 hours of Kwame.
Oh, shit.
Love those polka dots. The Curry Go, Jesus Spicer, Jamal Hashburn, the Bronx, Celine Dion, Ray and Nephew, the Reno, you cannot contain any human
memory
to Ja, Young Aaron, the racist provocateur, Henry Budcross, Nelson Mandela, Sergio, can't see me, Vladimir Boofin.
Damn.
The human worthings melting in your mouth. Mr. Beck, sounds like a thing. We can see Squabby, Greg Popovich. Look at my TED talk about white privilege. Morrison, Chestnut, Mahatma Gandhi. Not my Khabib, but I got that cucumber. The juice of the press, but your boy never is. I am not getting it. Yo, I gotta say that while they're dragging me around.
And it's straight dragging.
The Dunk Down and Ganoosh, no more cup of noodles. The Prince of Peckham, yes. Fight me. The Fashion Over Casanova, William H. Cent, 5 cent, 10 cent, dollar. For the small change, give me big money wine.
Yeah.
The only anthem I salute is Dipset.
That's right.
Mr. Stropping that street, easy with bad beats like I'm easy, please believe me. The Black Asiatic addict will crack your back like an automatic craftmatic. Mr. La Marina and Mess Marina with a fresh misdemeanor, cold demeanor, aka problematic babe.
Yeah, that's right.
I mean, why don't we just give Trump a chance?
Yeah, well, I mean, let him see what he can do. You know what I mean? Yeah, let's be bipartisan. You know who the fuck it is, man. Straight from East Tree, my nigga, standing with my fucking shirt off, nigga. I'm at Benzel Bush shopping. You know what I'm saying? It's your boy, the Kid Mero, aka the Human Durag Flap, aka Donovan McDab, aka Curb Gotti, aka Trans Khalifa. You know what I'm saying? AKA Skirt Loader, AKA James St. Fat. They call Ghost on you, shorty. Wait till I get out this orange jumpsuit. AKA I no fucking baby. I fucking main, nigga. To look home to my hookah store on Broadway. AKA check the guest list again, you fucking fat piece of shit. I swear to God, there's a fucking billboard with our faces across the street. I'll smack the shit out of you. Yo, call the promoter. His name is Mike. And I'm not stepping to the fucking side while you jack for the nigga, man. Get the fuck out of here. Yo, else chop this nigga's fucking face. I'll kill a spider with my bare hands, nigga, and pretend to eat it just to impress my kids, nigga, because I'm the fucking dad of the year, a.k.a. Bitch McMeanbo, a.k.a. Field Ass Tyson. I'm trying to explore your cosmos, man, a.k.a. Latin Messi, MVP of La Mota, a.k.a. Tom Brady. You shorty got my balls deflated, but Malcolm Butler got me. I'm holding it down. A.k.a. the Dominican Dundada, a.k.a. Barlo Santana, a.k.a. Dick and your baby Tumbo. You're not coming this pussy no more. I tell you one time, I tell you again. Even Jordan don't come in my lane. Beach ass nigga. AKA, Ben Boston, my hands are gifted. I will utilize them to replace your cranial cortex with Kaepernick's afro. Congratulations, you turkey. You are now righteous and woke. AKA, Lionel Dutchy.
Hello. Is it weed you're looking for?
Love this song.
Cause I can see it in your eyes that you're broken, so you're fine. No, you don't.
And don't you dare pull up in a tray bag, nigga, because I'll disrespect you in front of your friends. I'll open your fucking medicine cabinet, nigga. Please secure your benzos, because it's the fucking Zen, man. A.K.A. Rico Sabroso, A.K.A. Baby Newport. I got Lucy's on decky, A.K.A. Zaniel Bettingfield. I ain't got to get some sticks. I ain't got to get some sticks. A.K.A. Nino Brown. We got the car to shut down. A.K.A. East Tremont Stevie B.
I want to be the one your D.D. is fucking. Spring love, give me double toppy.
A.K.A. from across the ponds, I'm a little cranky because you cowers down to load tunes for niche. It's the plantain supernova in the sky. One day you will find me smoking weed on Tremont. Ooh. With a Porsche that I just crashed into a light pole. You know what I'm saying? I'm a 99 when I put my motherfucking hoodie on and like that gelato, nigga. It's Barmelo's Anthony! Fam, I know you see me at Bergen Town Center. I know you see me at the shops at Riverside. If you see me in Target trying to find Reese's peanut butter spread in the furniture aisle while Diddy and Rashida Jones are on Instagram Live offering me advice and praise, respect my fucking agency and approach me like an Earthside mammal, you fucking cowards, because I may react aggressively. You know what I'm saying? Hasan, dígame la pista que estamos en vivo de Locksmith. Quiero que mi gente llegó el hijo de Tito y FIFA, el más chulo de todos los chulos. Y ahora ando suelto en la calle. Llégale, mami. Si tú quieres ponerte nuevecita, tírame. Que te pongo esa nalga del año. El papi de la mami, Mero el primero. Dame banda aquerosa. Willy.
You can't tell me shit.
Yeah, yo, I woke up to that shit this morning like, yes, yes.
Every day we are lit.
We are fucking lit.
Every day, as it says in the Bible, every day we're lit. We are lit in God's grace.
That's right.
God created the earth and he was like, it's lit.
It's lit.
Oh, dinosaurs was like, yo.
Yo.
Yo, you dead ass.
You dead ass nigga. Yo, we lit.
I just imagine it was like the fucking Mario audience. God was just making shit. Was
like,
shit. Reacted like, he was like, yo, y'all want animals? Bring out the animals. Bring out the animals. Came from backstage and shit. Kangaroo was like, you don't judge me. You don't know my life.
The fuck out of here.
I got a pouch. Why these other niggas don't got pouches? Yo, imagine the first animal that see the kangaroo. Like, all the animals is like chilling and shit. I'll show you.
Yeah,
then
yo.
Fucking kangaroo come through. Just got his arms in the hoodie. Like, yo, no, what's good?
Niggas like, yo, you what the fuck?
That nigga got, yo, you got pockets, my dude?
What the fuck is that?
What the?
Yo, you pull it, nigga, pull it to the site, like, yo, who got a light? Kangaroo's like, oh, I got you. No. Nigga on his pouch.
Yo!
Yo, what the fuck is that?
Yo, my nigga.
I had to go back to the burrow to get a lighter, nigga.
This nigga came with pockets.
Yo, like, let's rob this nigga.
This fucking armadillo just get tight rolled to a ball. Like, fuck this.
This shit rolled down the hill.
Oh, shit. Episode 83, 82, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's right.
You know,
we're losing count on here because the art is timeless.
It's coming too fast, pause. No pause.
Sometimes you come too fast.
Pause, as in, like, we gotta slow it down.
We gotta slow it down.
Slow down. The track.
Beautiful. Rewinded. Beautiful Eurostep.
Oh, you know. That's
niggas are pros. Niggas are pros now.
Shout out to Boston. We was out Boston.
Shout out to Boston. The mean streets to Boston.
Did a nice little show there. Shout out to the people come through with the weed. We had to leave before you guys started booing the Patriots and calling them niggers for not standing. We literally was was on the bus after earlier. Yeah. We heard the chants. We were like, driver, step on it.
Yeah. Yo, the killer shit about this is that niggas think like, we do a show and then we just like hang out by the bar. Like, nigga, nah. Like, we just fucking just did cartwheels on stage for an hour. Nigga, we had to go back to the hotel and take an ice bath. Nigga, like,
literally.
Like, fucking.
I'll be looking like Patrick Ewing. We have like the mad patches of ice, like taped around my leg and shit. Doris Burke interview
with me.
Like, how do you feel about that show?
So, hey, Desus, you did great tonight. You're out there for 90 straight minutes.
Yeah.
How does that feel? I mean, you're really going hard out there. How do you feel that takes a toll on your body?
I mean, you know, you're just blessed to be out there. You just try to play the game the best way.
Yeah.
You know, I'm lucky to have a teammate like Mero.
You guys did amazing tonight. Yeah.
You know, it's thanks to the fans, their energy keeps us going. Mm-hmm. You know, the all praise is due to Christ.
Amazing.
It's the Trinity. It's me, Mero, and the Lord.
You know what I'm saying? Oh my God, amazing. All right, back to you in the studio, Jason.
He's a black guy. He probably did something wrong.
Jason,
yeah, that nigga's been my puncher back for fucking weeks, and it's just me too. Like, you're like, yo, you're going kind of hard on Jason. I'm like, fuck it.
I'm like, what is good enough? What is good enough? Because I feel like me you're and like, Jason, yo, chill, we're like, we all end up in the same room or some shit. And the thing is, like, I don't recognize people from like Twitter and TV and shit when I see them.
If that nigga pulls up with a hat, you would not recognize him.
No, and the thing is, I always look upset. I always look tight, like I'm about to swing out. So people be like, yo,
you have
I didn't want to approach you.
You have RGF, resting goon face.
You know what I'm saying? Like, resting goon face. You know, I'll be like, man, happy. I'm like, yeah, life is good. But I'll stop and look like,
nigga, I swear to God, nigga.
Shoot your mother through the peephole.
Yo, I'm having mad fun right now, nigga, but I will not hesitate.
Yo, this shit is lit. I should have brought my fucking Tim's. And then he's fucking at the hospital visiting babies and shit.
Oh,
just
shit.
Angry, like, look at this fucking beautiful fucking baby.
Look at him.
Put on some hell row.
Man, healthy.
For the whole nursery.
Yo, Ma, shut up. I'm about to spit that crack, Ma. Shit.
Shout out to all my real New Yorkers keeping their newborns in Timberland boxes.
I respect that.
You know what I'm saying? That's
real shit.
Why buy a crib?
Why do you don't need a fucking crib? A size 12 Timberland box with the tissue still in it. You got money.
You get the tissue from the Jordans. You
that's
put
it. That's it. You got a classy baby. You can take the shit from inside the toe. They can use that as a pillow.
Those little silica packets.
Yeah.
Keep your baby smelling brand new.
You know what I mean?
Because the worst thing is to get a crease in your babies.
Oh, so bad. So bad. When they start teething, you give them the silica gel too. Like, mm-hmm. Just chomp on that. You know what I mean?
It's free. This is a goop. We're starting a baby blog for real niggas.
Yeah. Oh, shit. When is it okay to send your child to the store for a Dutch?
Can I use a do-rag as a diaper? Yes, you can. Yes, you can. You ever use a? You never fucked with reusable diapers, right?
No, my brother did, and I was like, that's disgusting. Joints? Yeah, because like my fucking mother-in-law was like, yeah, we had cloth diapers. I was like, bitch, you're from 1940. I was like, everybody had good. Yeah. Like, I was like, get out of here. Like, you had a safety pin on your kid's diaper. Like, get out of here.
She was alive when like you get a block of ice. You know what I'm saying? In the morning, that was your water for the whole day.
Nigga, bitch, you had a
throw that shit in sawdust.
Fuck out of here.
Her next door neighbor is Betty Boop.
You know what I mean? I'm like, yo, Wilma Flintstones on the other side. I'm like, yo, you got a fucking milk. Man, like, yo, get out of here. Of course, you
was
cloth diapers.
Milkman, what the fuck is that?
Yeah, niggas,
that was, yo,
that's so sus. Like, I wouldn't trust that now. Nigga just puts a gallon of milk in front of your door and bounces. You don't know how long it's been there now. Like, come
people
on,
like, make America great again. They wanted to go back to when niggas had Netflix for milk.
That's crazy.
What the fuck is
yo,
that?
Yo, white people, I love y'all. You're crazy.
You know, we need milk at our door.
Why do you do stuff? Like, I went apple picking, and the whole time I was doing it, I was like, why am I? I was like, I love my kids, they're having a great time.
But now it's you understand slavery.
But I'm, yeah.
Now you get it.
I'm like, damn, I've been out here for 20 minutes and I'm sweltering hot, fam.
Like, yo,
and I'm in like the wild Nike dry fit shit. Like,
you're like, nah, fuck that. I'm going to get someone else to do this. Listen, if you ever put together IKEA furniture, at one point while you're putting it together, you understood how you could be a master on the plantation. Yep. You're like, fuck this.
Yep.
What's the minimum amount I could pay somebody to do this shit for me?
Oh, nothing? Oh, let's get it.
Let's go.
Yo.
IKEA just bought a TaskRabbit.
Oh,
which is a good service for you. Could get them. I think you could use them to stand in line for tickets for you to run.
All types of shit. Yeah.
But you usually use them to put together IKEA shit. So now it's like
that's crazy.
Now you could get IKEA furniture and have niggas come to your house and put together, and now you and your significant other don't have to get into a relationship ending fight because you're trying to put together a 6x6 bookcase, and she's like, I'm a woman, I have very small forearms, you like just lift it with your legs.
Yo, come on.
At the same time, one, two, three, go.
You're lifting with your back. You're lifting with your back, man. Come on.
Only two screws. Why you got extra screws over there?
There's not extras. They don't put extras in the package. Like, come on.
Halfway through, y'all just collapsing. Y'all just crying on each other. Like, yeah. Like, she flushed the coke. You're like, yo, we could get through this.
We could do it.
It's us against that bookcase, man.
It's just me and you, man. It's us. It's just us against Flugentagel.
Like, yo, we're going to do this. When you get that shit together, you'll be like, yo.
Fam, I haven't been into an IKEA in years. Mm-hmm. But there's an IKEA in Jersey I drive by every day, and the shit, I made a wrong turn into the shit, and it is like a city, nigga. Yeah. The street is called like IKEA Drive. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm like, yo, how could you? They got a daycare in that bitch. I'm like, yo, this shit is out of control, B. Like, you could live in IKEA.
You could.
They got meatballs, they got a bed, they got daycare. Like, I just get homeschooled and have Michael Beasley come through to play 1-on-1 every once in a while. You know what I'm saying?
In the parking lot?
Yeah.
I think Michael Beasley, didn't he work at IKEA?
He probably did. He probably still does. Who is the nigga that said that he works a job, or like he has a job because he doesn't like trust his NBA contract? I'm so mad I'm drawing a blank on that. But like, homie really said, I think it was Sprewell. No, it wasn't Sprewell.
It definitely was not Sprewell.
No, Sprewell said, like, how am I supposed to support my kids on, like, $50 million a year?
Shout out to Sprewell. They need to get Jerry West's old ass off the logo and make it Sprewell.
You gotta be Sprewell.
Make Sprewell, like, either choking out PJ Colissimo or him dunking with, like, the braids flying in the back.
Yes, I think him choking PJ is the move, though, I think. You're right.
That's the NBA That's still... The, yeah. White guys still run the NBA because, look, I'm saying, like, they asked Adam Silver. They was like, what's going to happen?
Yeah.
Season's about to start. Yeah. The niggas get allowed to take the knee.
Uh-huh.
And he was like, according to the rule books, according to stipulations set up by someone else, not me.
Sorry, guys, it's in the book. Sorry,
maybe David Stern.
I mean, it's not like I'm the president of this shit and I could maybe change the rules.
I just got here. Like, y'all think it is this Jew, not the other Jew. You know what I'm saying? I'm the cool Jew.
Yeah, it was a guy I got a baldy and shit. You know what I mean?
She's spelling the silver with the dollar sign. Yeah, like, you know what I mean?
Nigga, the A is upside down. ASAP Silver.
He's like, man.
He's like, yo, travel order stores now, guys. Come on.
Mm.
Yo. Oh, my God.
Do you remember Adam Silver fine Chris Jackson, a.k.a. Mahmoud Abdul-Rauf?
For changing his name on the jersey?
No. Cause,
I was about to say, that's a wild problematic.
He wouldn't stand during the national anthem, and then he just, because he was Muslim, and he just stayed in the locker room.
Why are people so concerned? Like, I never understood this shit. Like, I went to Catholic school for like 4 or 5 years, mm-hmm. and they made niggas stand for the national anthem. I didn't stand half the time, and niggas would give me like a detention slip. I'd just put the shit in my book bag and forget about it. What is the big fucking deal, B?
Because the thing is, people hear the anthem and the flag, and they automatically put it towards the military. Like, yo, this is what people die for.
You know what it is? It's because that stupid fucking statue. No one disrespected that, whatever. But the statue of the niggas holding up the flag and it's like mad heroic and whatever.
They
like, come on.
They romanticize the whole war thing and the military. And it's,
dog.
If you think about like the military, it's like, yo, oh my God, the military, these people are so brave. And it's like, usually, no, the people going to the military, they were just trying to get like a Dodge Charger or something.
Seriously.
Shit,
like, yo, I try to go to school for free or some shit like that. Like, niggas are like, I want to defend my country.
And then, like, the military comes back here. That's so fucked up. It's like, yo, you got to stand for the fucking national anthem.
Yeah, respect them. They get mad respect on Twitter, but when them niggas are shaking a change cup on the Fortran.
Niggas lock your door. Yeah, uh-huh. Yo, get away from me. You smell like bum piss.
Get out of here.
About that shit.
Niggas got mad medals on their jacket and shit. It's mad dusty. They're like, I don't give a fuck.
Hello, America. That's right.
The VA's in shambles, you fucking cowards. Why don't you do something about that?
Who's fucking Puerto Rico?
Yup.
Damn.
And niggas ain't doing shit.
They ain't doing shit. Like, Rihanna kind of send money. Yep. Beyonce, Pitbull,
fam.
J-Lo.
Daddy Yankee.
Is this the new shit now? Like, if you become famous and something bad happens to your homeland, it's up to you to repair it? That's just whack.
That's crazy. Damn. Especially if you're, like, a small island and it's, like, you don't have a lot of resources.
Yeah.
Shout out to my nigga Edgar over there holding it down. You know what I'm saying? I was going to say get well soon. That makes absolutely no sense.
That's some shit Donald Trump would say.
You know what I mean?
Shout out to Puerto Rico. Shout out to Puerto Rico. Get well soon.
Get well soon, please. Yo. I hope you guys get over this. You know what I mean?
Drink some chicken soup. You'll feel better.
Listen, you'll be okay. Yo, this shit is fucked up. And it's so easy for these rich countries to get together and be like, yo, let's just everybody kick in a little bit of money. Mm-hmm. Let's get these niggas back on their feet. Boom, boom.
But it's like, what's in it for them?
Nothing.
There's absolutely no benefit to
it. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I'm going to get a little fucking in my bag for a second. That's the whack thing.
Devils.
You know what I'm saying? Like, y'all can't just do something to be good. You know what I mean? Just to do something good for another human. Like, fam, these people have nothing.
Preach.
They took away their nothing. Mm-hmm. And now y'all niggas that have a surplus of shit don't want to kick a little something over there just so niggas can eat.
Just so they can eat.
So they can turn their lights on and take a shit.
Turn off the lights.
Come on, man. It's crazy.
It's crazy.
And I'm not even Puerto Rican. And the Puerto Ricans and Dominicans is supposed to not getting along. Who sent the money to Puerto Rico? DR. You know what I'm saying? Like, come on, man. Trump, Pito, step your fucking game up, nigga. I don't respect you, but send some money over there, you fucking clown.
I feel like this is the wild. This is Miro's Instagram Live telethon shit.
Call it right now.
There's a fundraiser for Puerto Rico. You can have celebrities come through and shit. He's like, yo, coming through now. Diddy. He's like, yo, take that. I'm in Miro's basement.
You pick up the phone like... Jesus, nice. Gotta hear both sides. How much would you like to donate?
What's your Square Cash saying? Niggas is scamming in money.
Shout out to Square Cash. You know what I'm saying? The sponsors. Sponsorito. If you don't know, not get to know, download the motherfucking app, you fools.
Square Cash.
You know what I'm saying? You need to, you know what I mean?
They want still to, do a Bodega Dream, still giving out money, you know what I'm saying? The Be Excellent Academy, all the day. Art Academy, shout out to them. They're still going well. You know
what I mean? Anna Sosa holding it down over there.
We're making little Basquiats in the Bronx.
That's right.
I was thinking about that the other day. Like,
one of them kids could end up being a fucking Basquiat, though.
Or just, like, hopefully one of those kids is just like, wow.
Wow.
Like, who are these two guys? Like, mm-hmm. Even if our shit flops, like, maybe this kid's like, they'll be like, yo, there was an art academy that someone paid for. I don't know who these people are, but you know
what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying? Niggas kept me from catching that stray in front of the bodega.
There you go.
You know what I mean?
We all have our, what is it, our close calls are in the Bronx. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. We're balancing out. We're balancing it out. That's right.
We're putting you in a safe environment so that you can learn and grow.
That's it. We're going to gentrify the Bronx in the best way possible.
That's right. Just make mad bodegas.
We need to make the Bronx like a fucking, like, what's that movie? The Black Panther?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
How they have, like, the self-contained Africa place? Yep. We're going to make the Bronx like that.
Self-contained Bronx. We good.
We're going to flip it. Remember how no one wanted to come to the Bronx? Yeah. They're going to be like, no.
Please. Niggas will be banging on the force field. Boom, 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 boom,
the
boom.
The Bronx is closed.
Please. I'm coming from Bed-Stuy. Please.
No.
I have cheeses.
No. The Bronx is closed. We just keep having, like, the Royal Imperial Remy guards dragging white people out. They snuck in via Ishimas. Bring them in front of the council. It's me, you, ASAP 12, via Cardi B. What should we do?
Toby's like, yo, burn this nigga with a cigarette. Nigga likes a new 400. I'm sorry, Masters.
Hang them at dawn at Yankee Stadium.
Derek Jeter's the hangman and shit. He's like, sorry, pal.
Hey, Jeter, let's go, Jeter.
Hang that asshole.
Oh shit,
public hangings in the Bronx, get ready.
We subsidized food for everybody. Everyone's like, yo, really? Chopped cheese again?
Yo,
it's free food for everybody. Keep moving.
You know how many grams of protein is in this shit, nigga? Let's with go. The cheese and the fucking meat.
I'm tired of this chopped cheese and shit.
Come on, son.
It's like Cuba, but it's just subsidized. Like, everyone gets tips.
You know what I mean?
Everyone gets, like, the wild Pele and shit.
Everybody gets a fucking 2004 Acura.
You move it, you get a pair of Tim's, camo shorts, a Yankees jersey, a Yankee fitted.
Yo. Oh, shit. A box of assorted Little Debbie cakes and shit. Like, yo.
A Honda CRX.
Cart of Newports and shit. Like, yo, here, hold this down. You know what I mean? You can sell them as Lucy's.
The big Fanta leaf. You can either use that to roll up or use it as a curtain. It's up to you. You know what I mean?
Like, the flag of the country of your choice, except the American flag. Yeah.
We just have posters of Big Pun. He's like Kim Jong-il. Like, every morning, people gotta get up.
Niggas are praying to him and shit. Niggas are praying to him.
There's rumors he's still alive. I heard he lives in. That's also gonna fail.
Oh, no. There's a back room where he lives. Yeah.
Fat Joe's running the country. He's like, he may or may not still be alive. To see all the Bronx people just lean back, like, I'm on the way.
Niggas get on the fucking Big Pun Capital Punishment vinyl to pray and shit. Like, yo, Capital Punishment, taste the choice.
Not Trump. I will nuke the Bronx. We will wipe them off the map.
We'll destroy them. If Rocket Man Jesus dares to threaten us again with threats of smoking Reggie, we will use the full fire and fury of the United States to eliminate the Bronx from the face of the earth.
Even Donald Trump was forced to lean back.
That's right, nigga.
Fat Joe's yelled at the U.S. He jumps in the pool with a fur on.
Yo, niggas just steps to the mic like, I got the mink on, same color the range. Joe, come on, Joe. Nigga brings out a Big Pun hologram and shit. Nigga sits on a stool like, oh, yo, shit. Thank you for coming, y'all.
They're like, we can't do a land war against the Bronx. These people will die. thousands of American troops would be slashed.
You see, the fucking triages, man, niggas with buck 50s, like,
my face. It looks like the Bronx is preparing for war. There's new footage. They show, like, the fucking rocket launcher in Van Cortlandt, but this shit just got the wild fucking box cutter on the back.
Yeah. They show waiting with a wild bandage on his face, like, we thought we had an advantageous position, but out of nowhere, Malik came and snuck me from behind with a rusty razor. I feel tremendous pain. I don't think we can win this war, y'all. That's right, nigga.
Niggas just throw the wild compound bucket over Manhattan. Niggas like, yo, if the Bronx does not stop firing, they don't stop these aggressive moves.
Niggas show Roman candles over the fence. Show that.
Yo, listen, you don't want it with the United States of the Bronx.
Nah, fuck out of here.
You don't want it.
You know what I'm saying?
The USB.
You know what I mean?
USB, all right?
If you shoot a bullet into the air, it eventually comes down and kills somebody. Is that possible? Is that an urban? Is that a myth?
No, it definitely has to come down.
It has to come down. But would it come down with enough force to kill somebody? Okay.
They did on Mythbusters. They said no. Yes, it happens all the time.
Okay.
And the thing is, like, if you fire up, it's not going to come straight back down.
Oh, no. But the wind is going to affect the trajectory.
You don't know where it's going to come down at. Yeah. So
whew.
Don't be firing guns in the air.
Yo, listen, 4th of July be easy. Just shoot the shit into the suit cap.
Okay.
It's actually the drain, not the cap. This shit is gonna ricochet, hit you in your balls. Shoot it right into the drain, like pow pow.
Ammunition's expensive.
It is.
I did
expensive.
Not realize.
It is
and then
very expensive.
People buy ammunition. They don't buy it like a box at a time. They buy like 30,000 rounds.
Because
you know, if you go to the shooting range, you know,
come off. You don't want to run.
You play GTA. You put in the cheat code.
Come on. You don't want to run out of bullets at the shooting range.
Fire a gun five times.
Come on, and then go home.
You want to get the fucking belt, the shit like...
We should go to the range.
We should?
Yeah.
Like the real range or like the hood range?
Both.
I'm saying... We
could just go to Millbrook right now, shoot an AK off the roof.
Straight off the... Just, man, chipping mad bricks off the fucking chimney and shit. Just spray paint a fucking body silhouette.
Yo, that's some niggas from the other side.
You know what I'm saying?
Just, hunting for a headshot.
Nigga just right on the fucking target. The op.
Yeah, like drawing dick in his mouth and shit, like I was on some problematic shit.
That's the thing about in New York, you don't really need to be. New York is like it's like Grand Theft Auto as far as shooting. Like you don't have to be specific.
No,
you're not gonna be specific.
You just gotta shoot in the general area.
Just be close.
Niggas is running regardless. Everybody's running. As soon as you start busting a gun, everybody's running.
Yeah, no one's really trying to go for like a headshot. And shit. You know what I mean? You're just trying to shoot. Niggas.
Yeah. And like, you don't want a headshot because then the nigga dies and then you catch a murder rap. Like, you rather shoot a nigga in the calf.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Do your little illegal firearm bid.
Nah, going to jail is mad whack.
It is. It's terrible. It is fucking the worst thing ever. I don't understand why people... I was going to say why people want to go to jail, but unless they wanted to get their teeth fixed.
Hold on a second.
You hear that too? I was like, damn, sick is farting on the low for mad long. I was like, god damn, nigga.
I was like,
how much cream you put in that cappuccino, my nigga?
All the cream. Shit is 90% cream, 10% milk. I looked the guy right in the face. He was like, Bobby, aren't you lactose intolerant? I was like, yeah, they got the nice bathrooms at Red Bull. Not bedroom.
They do, they got mad big bowls. You know what I'm saying? Like, you could go in there and take a wild slip.
I was like, whoa.
Wait.
Hey, yo.
They did hang dildos off the mirror for some reason at some point for some exhibit. Shout out to Red Bull, always cutting edge.
Always cutting edge, always pushing, shifting the paradigm.
I mean,
you know, you got to do, you know what I'm saying? You got to fuck niggas up with art. That's what we're going to do next year.
You know what I'm
saying? We're going to start making the podcast is no longer going to be audio. We're switching it to Braille. So if y'all niggas want to listen to the shit, we're going to have the big bro book.
Yep.
Niggas gonna be on the train reading shit with their fingers like.
Like,
what's so funny? Be like, here.
Yo, here. Touch it.
Braille is weird because.
Touch
like,
it, read it, nigga.
You always see they have Braille, like shit is written in Braille, but then it's like put in places like how would a blind person know to put their hands here to read the shit? Like,
I never said that shit. Like, I mean, like, are you supposed to automatically know what height every elevator button is at? Like, I don't get it.
Because like, all the hotel rooms, they have shit, and it's like different level. I imagine
it
like
should be behind the door and shit.
There has
like,
to be some sort of federal mandated height thing, but nah, man. Like they just be putting that shit anywhere.
Like, come on, man. Yeah, I gotta be nice to the blind people.
Is it blind or visually impaired?
Is it? Because I mean, it could be both.
I feel like visually impaired is more
on brand.
Apropos. It sounds better.
Yeah, the blind is
anytime,
like, you blind.
Anytime here. Someone uses a description for you that they were also using in 1920, you're like, nah, hold on, we gotta check this shit out. Because don't call me here, call them out. Oh, I love that podcast with the two colored utes.
Imagine somebody saying that shit on some mad complimentary shit, like
some wild Irish magazine, like, yo.
Oh, we love your show. Top ten
nigga podcast. What?
Like, whoa, my nigga, what?
They're like, oh,
yo, what the fuck did you just say to me, O'Shaughnessy?
The brand is strong. When these two niggers are in the building, you're like, whoa. Why do they keep saying that?
Why do they keep saying? We say that to each other.
It's different.
Yeah, nah.
Like, they're like, oh, well, if you could say it, why can't we say it? I'm like, nah, because when we say it, it's like a term of endearment, and like you were
But
actually, no, I don't want to lose. You know what?
This fucking
interview's
over.
Interview's over. Here. Shit. Next up in my favorite nigga podcast, Nigga Kid Fury and Nigga Crystal. I love the read.
Nigga Kid Fury coming like, you tried it. You really did.
They're like, yo, oh,
shit.
No, there's definitely people misinterpreting this podcast and listen to this shit and fucking. Eastern Europe, Belarus and shit. Yeah. Like,
those are my niggas, my favorite niggas.
My favorite niggas. Yeah. Nah,
my nigga was good.
Listen to, hey, nigga, it's time for our nigga podcast. Like,
yes. This shit translates directly into nigga podcast instead of Bodega Boys. Because they don't got bodegas over there, old boys.
And when the picture comes up at iTunes, it's us in blackface. Like, how did that...
How did y'all put
not the JPEG.
How did you put the white stuff around our lip?
How did my lips...
Come
fuck?
On, man.
Instead of us being at a table eating chicken, it's just like two big pieces of watermelon.
Like, hey.
Yeah. The theme music is way different. Some fucking vaudeville shit. Like,
Oh, man.
Oh shit, Rush Limbaugh died.
He did?
No.
I was about to be high.
Like, I just like to kill niggas just to kill niggas, you know what I'm saying?
Yo, Ann Coulter, how old is Ann Coulter? She's not anywhere near death, right? I mean, she's a living corpse, but I don't think
she died a long time ago.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
She's 55 years old.
Yeah, I mean, I don't wish death on people, but like.
I do, constantly.
If he wasn't dead.
For little things, too, like. Like, if I'm getting on the train, yes, I still take the train. Don't act up. When I take the train, though, it's not like y'all taking the train for like, y'all existence. I take it to be whimsical.
That's true.
It's like when rich people come back in the hood, like, my family used to live in this house. Can I just look around? That's me on the train. I'm like, wow.
Yeah.
I used to live like this.
I'll forever remember our interview with French Montana where he was like, I come through the hood, nigga. I don't go like this. I go like this. Nigga did the backwards pizza, like he's backpedaling out the hood. I was like, very smart.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? What, you know what I mean? But fucking, yo, come on, man. Just let niggas live. And it's funny because you said that because I'm low key fronting. Like, I do wish death on many, many people all the time. I'm just trying to front like I'm a good guy. Yo, I wake up in the morning, I'm like, I wish this nigga was dead. This nigga would be better off dead. I just don't want that energy to come back to me. Fucking vibes.
You know what it is? We've been away from LA too long.
We got to go back and get the good vibes.
Because remember how we got back from LA? We had just met with Pharrell.
Mad positive. Yo, help everybody.
I was listening to the podcast. We was like, we was positive and shit. We was talking lower.
Yeah.
We was very happy and shit.
Nah, now we're back to our usual nihilist selves.
Back to I got the jump started on my tongue like a wish
of
the
wood. You know what I'm
saying?
Yo,
I've been wearing a Nike tech suit for the last week and it's 90 degrees.
Please believe me. It's October, essentially. So Tech is out. It's Tech season.
Also, shout out to global warming that it's fucking October. We can't even wear our Tims. Well, I mean,
you know what I'm saying?
We do. Tims but I mean, rationally, you can't wear our Tims yet.
Unless you want the sweaty foot with the orange footprint on your sock.
It should be hoodie season. It's not hoodie season. Time yet, hoodie you season. Know what I'm saying?
I'm still out here suffering.
What are we supposed to do? What about all the Twitter jokes about women stealing hoodies?
You know what I mean? Come on.
You know, like, what about those guys? They need stuff.
They need material.
They need material.
Come on.
Pumpkin spice latte ain't drop yet.
You know what I mean? Not everybody.
For that.
Not everybody can be spontaneous and genius as us.
You can't be drinking pumpkin spice latte in 90 degree weather. Come on. Shit burning your top lip and shit.
Does that shit come iced? They're going to invent that. White people are going
to
invent that.
They have to
because of global warming, they're going to invent an iced pumpkin spice latte. You heard it here first on Bodega Boys, the number one podcast in the world.
Also, shout out to you. You predicted. Wait, no, did you? No, we predicted. And Desus versus Mero that.
And it's cancer.
Trevor Scott.
Oh, shit.
Would knock out Kylie.
Yo!
Called it.
And it happened. And Shorty's 20.
Okay.
Good. I mean, it don't matter what fucking age these
nobody knows what that baby is going to look like. Because she's had so much work and he's had so much work.
That baby's gonna come out like it's lit, looking like fucking Rob Kardashian. Like, whose kid is this?
Like, yo,
nigga's gonna come out Asian. Like, who? What?
They better put that baby should get plastic surgery right out the womb.
Well, out the nigga in the womb.
Just like, yo.
In vitro fucking titty job and shit.
Come out with the little black eyes after the nose job and shit. Like, they'd be like, oh, this is the first time a baby can get like a nose job. First time in history and they have it on Keeping the Kardashians.
Shit is on TLC, like, the first ever. The Bodega Boys are going to perform along with Dr. Ben Barson in vitro butt shots. Let's see how this turns out.
Now they have to make Fashion Nova diapers for the babies with the yeeks.
Yo, if your waist don't fit your ass, use Fashion Nova diapers.
Got the little skinny legs with the wild yeeks. This is weird.
What's going on
also,
here?
Also, they gotta give the baby another K name.
Gotta
keep niggas the brand going.
They're gonna run out of K names.
Damn, they're gonna keep the Kardashians going until like at least 2050.
Fam. They're gonna do that thing where you run out of letters, so you have to double the K, and eventually they're gonna get to KKK, whatever.
Okay, I don't think that's gonna happen.
They're gonna get to KKK Kardashian.
No, no, bro. No, don't put that in the universe. Don't you put that in the universe? Yo,
fucking unbelievable. I don't hate the Kardashians, but they're just somebody. I read this shit on Twitter and it blew my mind. I was like, yo. Imagine Ray J never took his video camera on vacation with him. What would the world be like?
We need to make a movie where we go back and
take Ray J's camera.
Ray J run out of film. The Kim Kardashian tape never happens.
Yo.
Donald Trump never becomes president.
Yo.
Because America never gets addicted to the teat that is reality TV.
Yo, correct me if I'm wrong. Victor's out doing very important business calls. You have the computer. Was Arnold Schwarzenegger getting voted as governor pre-Kardashian? Yeah. Because it was?
What was he, mayor?
Governor of California.
Pre-Kardashian.
If that's post-Kardashian, that's post-Kardashian effect all the way.
All right, he was in 03.
I think that's post-Kardashian.
Yeah.
What is Kardashian,
the sex tape or the show?
Definitely the sex tape and the shit right prior to the sex tape when she was.
Sex tape was 02.
Ah.
It might be on something. Oh, wait, no. The sex tape was recorded in 02 but came out in 07. So.
Oh.
Damn. We had something.
Damn, we had something going.
See how facts ruin the fun?
Fuck.
We
can still run with that.
Fuck facts.
You know what I'm saying?
Every time you're having a good time, facts is just like, it's just like you out having a good time with Shorty. Shorty vibing with you vibing with her. Y'all feeling each other. Yeah. And then, you know what I'm saying?
Facts just pull up on you like.
Facts just pull up like, yo. Get off my husband. You're like, you know why? Well, why are you bringing that up?
Come on, man.
Why? I'm married when I'm with you, man.
Like, come on, like, you know what it is?
Did he told you?
You
chilling and shit. You just have your weekend to yourself. Come on, man. Like, your kids, man, what the fuck?
What's
like,
going on?
Your kid, you left your kid in the car, and you're like, oh,
fuck. Oh, shit, Waze forgot to tell me.
Yo, I saw you ran against that. That shit is weird, because like, when you have no kids, it's like, yo, check your car for kids. I'll be like,
what?
Fuck?
Yeah, this shit told me that shit getting out of a fucking car. Like, not my car. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, I say a car. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, a luxury car service. You know what type of this. I jumped out of the whip, shot the hinge, you know what I'm saying, number one. And the shit was like, hey, make sure you don't leave a precious cargo in the car. And I was like, did my phone just ask me to check for my fucking kid in the car? I was like, yo, what kind of person do you think I am?
But it happens.
That's so wild
it
to
happens.
Me, bro.
I imagine if you got, like, a big SUV.
Yeah.
You got mad kids.
How I got four though, and I can keep track of them. And that's what bugs me out. I'm like, yo, I'm like, fam, and I don't know if it's just because I got my kids are boisterous, and would be like, yo, son, like, yo.
Nigga said my kids are boisterous. Yo, that's how you know this nigga getting money. This nigga is using hopeful words. Like,
yo,
my kids
that's
are
a polite way to say I got badass kids. And he would be like, yo, nigga, as soon as I park the car, they take
this
shit off.
Get your boisterous ass over here.
Yo. No, chill. You can't open that in the store. Yo, I got to pay for that, my nigga. Yo, my kids open shit, bro. You know the little blind bags? Like, action figures that come in bags. It's like a mystery. Like, it could be Wolverine. Oh, okay. It could be Deadpool. Yeah. It could be whatever. Yeah. They pick those up. They just start opening them. I'm like, nigga, no! I was like, and I gotta buy 10 of these shits. I was like, fuck, bro. I can't get arrested. Like, on some Cat Williams shit, getting arrested at Target? God damn, bro.
See what happens.
They can't.
See what happens. I'm going to get arrested at Target.
Is that good for the brand or bad for the brand?
Arrested at it depends what you get arrested for.
Yeah.
Because I'm doing a new kind of slow shoplifting at Target.
Uh-huh.
What I do, you know how there's kitty litter? Like the kitty litter comes out the box and be all over the shelf.
Ah.
So I do, I scoop it into my hands.
Ah.
And I walk out with it. And I figure after like 30 or 40 trips, I'm going to have enough for a free box of cat litter.
You know what you do? Bring one. Next time you get Chinese food, just take the old Tupperware from the Chinese food. Throw it in there. Boom.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Foolproof. Tape it to your chest. You know what I'm saying? So niggas don't detect you. You know what I'm saying?
No, I left Target the other day and a kitty litter was underneath the cart because dumbass niggas was like, yo, let me see your receipt. I was like, nigga, you really think I'm stealing cat litter? And then why all of a sudden why the nigga also shout out to us going to Hood Target, well me, because they check the receipt when you're leaving.
Oh, to my furniture?
Because they don't check the receipt in the nice Targets. And then when they check the receipt when you're leaving, the nigga turned from just a high school graduate into the fucking head forensic scientist.
Nigga,
the
fucking
order.
James Comey and
nigga
shit. Like
the fucking eyeglass shit, the jeweler wear shit.
I'm
going
like, yo,
over the shit.
When did fucking Mueller become the fucking Target security guard?
Yo, you hand over your receipt. You're doink, doink. You're like,
yo. The receipt's still warm. He raped her.
He's like,
what? Whoa.
He's like, stand over there. We gotta wait for the forensic evidence to come back.
Wait,
like,
what?
It's orange juice, a pair of socks.
What the fuck,
what the
bro?
Fuck?
They go to the ME's office and shit. She's dissecting the receipt. Like, yo, no, he didn't pay. He's stealing things.
It's like, yo, this receipt was printed on waxed paper.
Oh,
like, what?
Shit.
Boom, boom. He's standing there like, yo, my left is hit. Like, could you get out the way?
Yo, come on, dog. Here's $100. Let me get out of here.
Or when you walk out and they're like, excuse me, I got to check your receipt. You're like, or else what?
Oh, what?
Nigga, I'm already out the store.
You going to chase me, nigga?
You going to chase me? You ready to die for the Target
you
shit, my nigga?
Come on.
As soon as you raise your voice like that, they back to reality.
Like, oh, shit. Yo.
Right?
Word. I got GD class tomorrow. I can't miss that shit. No.
You guys are walkie talkie. You know what I got? Bloodlust. You want to die for that nigga?
You know what
to target? You!
Yo, shout out to fucking New York City. Shout out to Mount Vernon. Shout out to all the adjacent places because the Mount Vernon Target, they shut it down for a little bit because it was an unsafe structure. I was like, damn, this type of shit ain't supposed to happen in New York.
Listen,
like, what the fuck?
I mean, it happens. So like, when you build in the Bronx, sometimes you don't got enough money for all the cement. So you might mix a little newspaper.
A little sand, a little B12.
Some old junk man and shit. Listen.
Some soap and shit. Nah, it's Krills.
You will like lean on a wall, your hands just go through the shit. Your landlord would be like, yo, I mean, like, why you was leaning on the wall?
Why you leaning on the wall?
Who leans on walls?
I put it right here. No
you
lean.
You stand on floor, you don't lean on walls. What the fuck is wrong
no
with you?
No lean on wall, Poppy. That says Nolan wall. I don't say that. I don't say no lean.
Also, shout out to Bronx landlords that you call them, and what you think is a pressing emergency, they're like,
all
right, well, I'll see if I can get around to it.
Yeah. Grease fire? Damn. Oh, no.
I had a landlord that had a full-time job, and it wasn't being a landlord. Like, I was like, what the fuck? Like, I called in a panic because my neighbor's water was coming up out my bathtub.
Yeah.
Because I come home and, like, the floor would be wet.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, what the fuck is going on? I thought, like, Rocco or somebody had, like, got into the bathroom and turned on the thing. And I was like, I couldn't figure it out. And then one day I woke up mad early and it was, like, all these foams was coming out the... It was, like, the dirty water from my neighbor's showers and shit. And I was like, I called the landlord pronto. And I was like, yo, fam, like, you got to take care of this.
This is backing up.
And your man's like...
Yo, you can call me back. Like, now's not a good time. I can't really use my phone right now. I'm at work.
I was like, pardon?
What?
So I was just... like, pardon, Jose? Did you say you can't talk right now? He's like,
yeah. It's like, hold on, my boss is coming. I'm gonna come. Hold on. Yeah, that's an unlimited data plan. You get 6 megabytes.
Excuse me, Jose.
Give me 1 second. I'm just. I'm putting on hold for 1 second.
Yo, there's water coming out my bathtub.
So yeah, with the T-Mobile extra plan, what you get is unlimited minutes and text messages.
Unlimited. You dead ass, my nigga.
Yo, I'm sorry, man. Come on, I'm trying.
Yo,
come on, man.
When you gonna come to my apartment and fix this shit?
Nigga, come on. I'm trying to get to this money, bro. Mama Sushi's lit tonight, yo. B-O's over there, man. Come on. You know what time it is, bro. Come on, let me live, bro. Come on.
Yo, I was like, yo, fam, what the fuck? And I called, like, the real estate, the rental group that owned the building. And them niggas mad. They were like, we'll send over, like, a plumber. Like, they was doing me a favor and shit. I was like, come on, fam. Like,
fam.
They knew it was the Bronx. They're like, where the fuck you moving to?
Fam, I almost spazzed on a landlord one time because I was... not even late with the rent check, but it was like, if you have the rent check on the day that it is due, you mm-hmm. can go to the office and deposit the rent check. Mm-hmm. So I do exactly that. I go to this shit. It's like half an hour till they close, and they close. And I'm like, yo, banging on the door. I'm like, yo, rent. I have my rent check. I have my rent check. And Shorty opens the door, and then fucking Shlomo comes behind the counter and is like, I'm sorry. It's too late to deposit your rent check. You're going to have to pay an over fee for late payment. I'm sorry. I'm like, Shlomo, it's 5:45. You close at 6, my nigga. I have your check right here, right now. You know what I'm saying? I was like, yo, you are officially uninvited to my Seder, my nigga, because you really violate me right now. You gonna make me pay $100 extra? I'm here now, bruh. And the nigga really did not let me pay the shit. So then he bounced, and the Puerto Rican lady was like, let me get it, papi. I'll process it for you. Don't worry.
Shout out to Puerto Rican. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to all the Puerto Rican mommies out there.
Puerto Rico.
You know what I mean?
Yo. I don't know about that life, because
that shit is banging, bro.
Shout out to the sponsors, Schubert's Lemonade. That only the best will do.
That shit is so good. You can mix that with the shittiest vodka in the world, and this shit will work.
Yeah, I'm not drinking today. My body's tired. It's been a long week.
It's been a long week.
It's been a long week. But I'll probably drink later tonight, though. But
I'm going on a tear tonight. I'm gonna go on a tear tonight. Yeah.
No, shout out to our, when I was paying rent, I was behind the rent. Because then when you first, the first time, when you paying rent, you always on time, you're like, yo, you're all jipper and shit. Yeah, like, yo, first of the month, got my rent too. Then when you don't have, you be like, third of the month,
hey,
got the rent.
Hey, what's up? Hey, listen, had some emergencies.
So got that money though. Here when it you is. Reach that point where you like, you're not paying it to like the 15th and shit. You got to do it with, like, your chest. Like, yo. Here's the rent. What?
Yo.
Yeah, at least you got it.
Yeah, at least you got it, nigga.
I
know I owe you last month, nigga, but take this now, mm-hmm. and I'll come back with the shit later. You shout want money or
everyone,
not?
Shout out to everyone paying rent, and you created your whole different rent payment schedule than what you originally signed up for. Like, your landlord's like, yo, the rent is due on the 1st, and you was like, no. When I pay my rent every 27th of the month, that's when I'm paying. And I'm only paying half, my nigga.
And you'd be probably you paying early and shit?
Yeah.
He's like, no, that's this month,
that's
my nigga.
That's this month. They'd be like, yo, how your rent is 2 G's and you just gave me a G? It's like, nah, like, put that, that's for last
that's
month.
Put it towards that, and then I'll come back with something. I got you. I got a lawsuit coming through in like 2 months. Like, trust me.
My landlord was like, they was like, yo, you are 3 months behind. They was like, even if you pay up, you ought to be out by the end of the month. I was like, well, if I don't got money for the last 3 months, where the fuck I got money to move? To nigga, I was like, you come get me out this shit.
Yeah.
Just sitting there under mad pressure and shit.
Yeah.
The most embarrassing part of that is because when they do the eviction shit, they put the mad sticker on
your door.
And I lived on the ground floor. Mm. And if you live on the ground floor and you have mad West Indians passing, I don't want to get the dirty looks in the courtyard.
That shit is neon. It's neon. It's not like a regular, it's not black and white. Neon. Like, yo, you bum ass nigga. They should just have a LeBron's face on it. Like, you bum.
You bum, you're behind.
Bum.
And you feel bad because you're like, damn, I can't pay my rent. All the other people are paying your rent. Nigga, I was talking to some lady in the building. She was like, yo, 60% of this building is vacant or behind on their rent. Like, yo, join the club.
Yeah,
niggas,
who cares?
Niggas meet at the patty shop every Thursday to laugh about how they not paying the landlord and shit.
Yo, like, yeah,
I spent my money in the susu. Niggas I'm like, oh, shit.
Niggas, like, niggas in the laundry room laughing, yucking it up with a bottle of Henny. Like, not doing no laundry, just down there smoking weed.
Are you paid?
Stupid. Oh, you paid? Dumbass nigga. I copped this ounce.
Because there was a lady and she was like wild behind on her rent, and I see her moving into wild 60-inch TV, and I was like, oh, that's how we live it?
That's ballsy.
I was like, I ain't going nowhere.
That is very ballsy.
And then the real estate agent is like, yo, if you don't pay, I'm like, what?
What? You gonna do what? What
you
gonna
go do?
You gonna kick me out?
My shit's good.
You gonna kick all 70 of these niggas out?
I could go to housing court, get at least another 6 months. So,
let's go.
You feel a froggy
leap. Let's get it, baby.
Matter of fact, I might kick a hole in the wall.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I'm getting illegally. You paying for the lawyer. What's up?
I might, you know what? Sounds like I'm about to let the water and the bathtub run for just no reason
for
whatsoever.
For no reason whatsoever.
Might warp the floorboards.
Who cares?
Matter of fact, let me throw out this kitty litter and let my cat pee everywhere.
That just triggered me, bro. I got to pay fucking $5,000 to replace my AC unit, yo, because the shit leaked through the fucking my kid's room. Fuck.
Homeowner problems.
God damn it.
Damn.
But we got it, though.
I'm just saying, it's a... Wow. That's how much?
$5,000.
Damn.
It's central air. You know what I'm saying? And
that's not no book boy shit.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? You got to have central air. You got to walk into your crib and automatically feel refreshed as soon as you're walking through the foyer. You know what I'm saying? Yes, I said foyer.
I mean, that's something unique. It's still very warm. It's September 29th.
It's September 29th. Dog, it's 90 degrees. Dog, I woke up today and it's 60 now. Yo, niggas are like, yo, global warming is fake. That shit is climate change is not real. Fam, we've had six hurricanes in the past month and a half? Mm-hmm. Like, yo, come on.
But you see, it's not, that's the thing. It's not, you can't say that it's climate change.
It's HARP.
It's not HARP. No, it's straight. You know what it is? I mean, I don't like to get preachy on here, but it's clearly God's wrath at the homosexuality that's rampant in the mainstream media.
Got something listening to the TLK and shit? We are going to rain Pondi Chichi Man Bar. Like, yo, chill. You can't say that. You can't say that.
That's such a very specific thing. Like, was just the earth was just chilling. The guy was like, yo, everything's good.
Yeah, everything's good.
Hold up.
Them niggas having sex.
Two niggas kissing?
What?
Set some frogs down there.
Yo. Yo, hold these locusts, nigga. You like anal? Hold these locusts.
What was the, when they went the Ten Commandments and shit? I wonder what that was like, because remember, who was it? Moses went up there and got him?
Is that a really good, yo, I'm an awful Catholic. I was raised Catholic by my parents because they're Dominican and everybody in the DR is Catholic.
Yeah, Moses goes up the top of the mountain.
And comes back with
like the two tablets. My question is,
do you know the Ten Commandments off the top of your head?
They're like easy. They're
thou
like
shalt not kill.
Lazy.
Thou shalt not
run off on the plug.
Yeah,
they're not important. I don't live by them. I just live by, yo, don't owe niggas money and niggas run off with work to get that hot one.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Fuck up a pack, I'm going to fuck up your back.
Yeah, like what happened? Did he go up there and God was like, yo, here's two stones? Or did he go up there and God was like, yo, you ain't bring the tablets, my nigga?
Or did he go up there with a fucking cone of gelato and be like, yo,
this nigga was up there,
instrumental, like, yo,
turn my beat up.
Yo,
turn my beat up.
Yo, number one, yo. Boom, 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 yo, never keep pack where you rap. No, hold up. Thou shalt not kill.
Nigga lied to them. I was like, yo, I gotta get some me time and shit. He was like, yo, I gotta go to the top of the mountain.
Yeah, God called me.
God called me up there.
Yeah,
shit.
Nigga called
like,
me.
Nigga like, this perfect time.
Yo,
it's
he called me. Yo, look, I got like six missed calls. Yo, it's emergency. I gotta go up there.
They're like, where you going? Moses, come down. He's like, nah, I'm walking on my verse. Yeah.
He's like, niggas walking up the mountain like, these niggas ain't chipping on this fucking blunt. Fuck out of here.
My shit. Come on. To the face.
Fuck out of here.
You know what I'm saying?
I made mana come down from heaven. And niggas want to hit the backwards. Get the fuck out of here.
Like, yo. Put on that Harry Frog beat. We're rappers are monkey flipping with the funky rhythm. I'll be kicking. My shit. You know what I'm saying?
La música de Harry God.
I'm like Scarface sniffing cocaine, holding the M16. See with the pen, I'm extreme. Niggas don't know about the Moses flow. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, nigga comes out with two tablets. I'm in the Lex watching Kathy Lee and Regis. Everybody's like, yo, what the fuck does that mean?
Yo, he's like, they're like, yo, is that the word from God? Is that the Ten Commandments? He's like, this is my SoundCloud link. Please check it out.
Check it out.
I got fire beats.
Lil Uzi type beat.
I got a collab with Lil Pump. It's not him, but it's his vocals.
It's his vocals. He emailed me something while he was on Zans.
Niggas is booing.
Fuck out of here.
The Ten Commandments is whack.
Oh, shit.
How did they even do it? It was like a fucking Apple keynote address and shit.
Right?
Nigga stopped at 1 o'clock. Was like, yo, we got to go get the Ten Commandments
Also, how long did it take to carve Ten Commandments into fucking tablets? Like, it's not like you had the fucking Big Pen. You could just be like,
if that would be the flex of God, was like, bang, and them shits was done. Like, how whack would it be if God was like, you know, I'll write these down. Yo, I'm going to say them out loud. You got to write them down and shit.
Nigga just throw a chisel at the nigga here. Okay.
Commandment number one.
Nigga,
hold on, slow down.
Yo, there's two M's in commandment,
down.
You dumb motherfucker.
Slow down. I never even made the fucking...
Oh, my God.
You could at least put... How many...
Put one, nigga. You got to put a parentheses after the one, or else it just looks like one child not kill. What the fuck does that even mean?
You want, like, a regular one, or, like, a Roman numeral?
A Roman numeral. My nigga, come
Roman,
on. It's
the
AD.
Roman's gonna kill your son, so...
It's BC, though. We'll cross that bridge when we get to it, man. Come on.
Okay.
Get it together, bro.
I mean, like...
Come on. I got to make it rain honey again for these niggas, man. Come on. You slowing shit down, my nigga.
Okay, hold on. Okay.
You know what? Fuck this. Yo, Tim Tebow, come over here. Tim.
What's up, Dad? What's going on, Dad?
Yeah. Yo, can you do this Ten Commandments, please, for this nigga, man? He's slowing that shit up.
Got you.
All right, now get this shit to Moses. Now, Moses, go down there and do your thing, my nigga. Please.
It's Tim
God
Tebow.
Damn.
He shouldn't even be in the league. Ten Commandments is whack because the first one is y'all shall have no other gods before me. And that directly goes against being Bodega Hive.
That's true.
Because if it comes down to your Lord and Savior or new art, I think I know which one you're picking.
You're skipping church for this for sure.
God's like, you can go to purgatory or you can get a Bodega Boys t-shirt. They're like, is it the chopped cheese ones? Because I really wanted that one
and it was sold out. I wear extra large and I bought a small just because.
This is when people on their deathbed go be like, the bread. It's strong.
Speaking of merch, Victor just pulled up in here with fucking kilos, nigga, of the merch.
Wow.
Yup.
What's he doing?
Uh-oh.
Oh, the Mr. Oh, Red. That's shit. The Supreme.
Uh-oh.
If you got the black chopped cheese shirt,
yeah,
whoa,
that's
nigga.
The well, nigga, that's the Supreme mini bike.
That's it. That's just
that's the Supreme Louis V shit.
In order a collaboration with Supreme to help the Caribbean islands affected with the hurricane, we're making Supreme limited edition Supreme branded Caribbean items.
Yeah.
I got the cutlass coming. Yeah. I got the malaria net.
A nice machete with the sharpening stone and shit. You know what I'm saying? How about Supreme gallons of water?
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? How about that?
That should be mad hype. Don't open it.
Chill.
It's collected.
Yo,
don't,
come on. Don't open
water.
It. Don't drink
chill,
it. No, chill. You can't drink it and then refill it. Nah, it loses value.
We're going to send mad Supreme bricks to rebuild the Caribbean and shit.
Niggas will be having fucking $800,000 houses, not even knowing.
They're like, what the fuck? They're like, how is my house valued at $1 million?
I shit in an outhouse. I shit in an outhouse. How's my house $1 million?
Every time niggas pass by. Hypebeast.
Hypebeast.
Hypebeast. You don't even, only you like the label.
Yeah, you don't even skate.
You were underwear before Kanye.
You're a kook.
Oh man. So FEMA just don't work no more?
Nah, FEMA don't care.
FEMA was laying low, and then Katrina was like, yo, like there's a group of people that come save you and shit. Now FEMA's like, nah,
fuck
out
of here. Not for nothing. FEMA is like,
yeah. You know what it is? It's like if you are married and then there's another kid. But it's not your kid. You're like, technically that's my kid.
I guess.
But that's not really my kid.
I don't want to drive you to school.
Yeah.
You know
so
what
that's
saying?
What
like,
Puerto Rico is to America. Yeah. It's like, yo, you got states. Yeah. And then there's them niggas.
Yeah. Until the niggas get drafted. And then they're like, oh, we always loved little Joaquin. He was our shining star.
See, the rest of us, we know about the Virgin Islands and Puerto Rico and DR shit. Yeah. So we're like, that's why I'm like, yo, it's part of the United States.
Yeah.
Everyone else is like, not really. Like, them niggas is, they like, it's an island. And niggas is like, well, Hawaii is an island.
Yeah.
You accept that shit.
Yeah.
They're like,
that's why God blessed DR and had them two hurricanes skirt them, you know what I'm saying, and just very lightly hit. You know
so
what
about the other islands? God doesn't fuck with
No. That's what I'm saying, because the Dominican Republic rebelled against the Jacobean American devils. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my uncle who has a picture of him with the AK, with the fucking wild old looking Tommy gun and like the goofy hat and shit, like ready to kill Jacobs. You know what I'm saying?
It's a very problematic statement.
It's a powerful image.
Very problematic. This is why DR and Puerto Rico have beef. Comments as that.
No, Puerto Rico's gonna be all right. But the problem is, they're not going to be all right because of the United States. If the United States would do what they were supposed to do, they'd
be
okay.
Puerto Rico needs to, this is their time for them to establish their independence.
I mean.
Like, listen, if the United States is not going to take care of them, they got to do for themselves.
And there's been debates about that for years. Mm-hmm. And I've always been like, yo, Puerto Rico should be independent. And you know what I mean? Like, as a Dominican,
well,
like,
I mean,
whatever.
It's not that easy to go independent.
Obviously not. Yeah, yeah. Because you need,
unless you sign the Koch records, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly. You know what I mean? They can do your own shit, go viral. You know, Chance did it. But if they were independent, yeah, they would struggle or whatever. But, like, I think it should be the duty of the United States to put them on their feet and then grant them independence. You know what I'm saying?
And Donald Trump is like, wrong.
Fuck out of here.
Fuck out of here.
Why the fuck would I do that? That would cost me millions and billions of dollars.
Why would I like to subsidize an army of cocoa gelato?
Why would I do that? Cocoa,
fuck
mango,
that.
Cherry. I don't like cocoa, mango, or cherry.
Okay, what would their capital be? Fordham Road?
Fuck out of here.
Fuck that.
It's incorrect. No. Daddy Yankee is prime minister. Won't stand for it.
No.
They will drive up the price of gasolina.
Let me ask you something. You want to look into the audience, the general counsel of the UN, and see a guy with three slits in his eyebrows?
Yo, don't do business with Jacobean devils, nigga. Nah, you can do business with Jacobean devils.
Oh, there's several reasons why Puerto Rico can't go independent.
Why?
Its current standard of living is artificially high when compared to other nations in the Caribbean. They'd have a difficult time paying for energy. They're being floated for the U.S. now, and its brain drain would be almost nearly absolute, because as soon as like they became independent, like everyone would be like, yeah, we out of here and go to America.
Oh.
So that's a couple of reasons. I'm sure some of y'all are going to hop in the comments and write the wild thesis about why they can't go independent. Let me save you some time. I don't read those.
TL semicolon DR.
Everything you type in my comments, I look and I'll be like, maybe. I'm not going to comment. Like a little girl today was like, we're getting paid money. We got paid money to talk poorly about Nicki's verse on Rake It Up 2 podcasts ago. She said the industry has people going against Nicki Minaj. So in her mind,
what?
We're taking money to talk poorly about Nicki Minaj's verse on Rake It Up. The bitch said China eight times.
Eight times.
How?
And the entire thing started with everybody knows who we are, bro. We're Bronx guys. We want to lift up and elevate people that come from our circumstance. Cardi B is one of those people. Cardi B used to dance. Now she doesn't do that anymore. She makes money moves.
Hey.
You know what I'm saying? So
has that been a Jeopardy clue yet? I want to hear Alex Trebek say it.
She used to dance, but now she makes money moves.
Who is Gloria Estefan?
Oh no, wrong. It's actually Cardi B. Cardi B from Highbridge in the Bronx. Shout out to High Flybridge. Free my nigga.
Flybridge.
He ain't do shit.
We need a whole category of Jeopardy, just Bronx. And all the
crazy
Bronx people.
Oh man, that'd be great. Like, they do stupid shit all the time.
All the time.
All the time.
I just have the white people out there confused, like, what the fuck?
What the fuck?
The fuck?
When did he go from Fat Joe the gangster to just Fat Joe? I didn't know that.
This popular Dominican not only is dad of the year, but it also goes by the plantain supernova in the sky. People are just like,
Who is Ray Romano?
No.
Who
is Ruben Diaz Jr.?
Sorry.
Senior.
Also incorrect. Also, sorry. Sorry. It's actually, the answer is the kid Mero from East Tremont.
All the white people look around like, who is that?
That was a tough one. It's like, Daily Double.
I didn't know that one either. I did not know this one either.
I'm not going to hold you, my nigga. I didn't know that one either.
Like Bronx for 500 is like, this popular African-American also comes from Jamaican descent and popularly complains about his mother buying meat with too many bones. Who is Maccabee? I just come out and say, like, fuck.
Nigga,
I said I'm not Maccabee, but I got the cool combo. What the fuck
is wrong with you niggas in the audience? Make sure niggas get the answers right.
Every time it's supposed to be me, like, they keep saying Maccabee. I'm like, what the fuck?
I'm
not Maccabee. What the fuck?
You're going to become Maccadesus? That's going to be like your Pokemon final form?
Maccadesus. Instead of like the way Maccabee talks about vegetables being good for you, I'm talking about types of weed and shit.
Yeah.
It's like, gelato.
Gelato.
Good for your blatto.
Oh, the wedding cake. It make your blood bump boil. I don't even know what the
make
fuck runs
shake.
With it.
Yeah.
Yo, shout out to weed. Weed is great.
Shout out to weed. Shout out to us.
You know what I'm saying? Of course.
You know, for no reason whatsoever. We're going to be in Toronto.
That's right. T-Dot.
Out here.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? You got
so pull up. We're trying to have fun out there. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
Are we in and out again?
In and out.
In and out?
In and out like a robbery. We don't stay in people's towns.
Yeah, that's right.
You know what I'm saying? We not. Listen, mom. People always are like, town for one night. You
that's
know what I'm saying?
We always get, not pressed, but like inquired upon. I should check out this restaurant. Yo, this thing is a dope. I'm like, yeah, bro, we're leaving at 5 a.m. on a red eye.
Out of here.
Like in 2 hours.
Out of here.
Yeah.
Shout out to Toronto, the six, or you know as they call it, the T-Dot.
You know what I'm saying?
It's going to be good.
Yo,
we're
Drake.
We're going to jaywalk, and we're going to stop traffic.
That's right. We're going to eat poutine. Is poutine a thing in Toronto, too?
It's all over Canada.
It's all over
their
Canada?
National anthem.
All right, cool.
I'm going to kneel during their national anthem.
You have to
and
do
they're
it.
And they're going to be like, why are you kneeling?
Why?
And I'd be like,
Sacre bleu.
Sacre bleu. I'd be like, this is for all the, what's the injustices going on in Canada?
Justin Trudeau wore Chewbacca socks to the UN.
That's not.
That's not an injustice?
All right,
I guess it's a Canadian justice.
We'll find some.
It might be seen as impolite.
There's a couple.
Maybe somebody at the hotel when we check in will be not as polite as we would expect from a Canadian. Maybe. Okay. I don't know.
Canadians are not that polite. Like, they are polite, but not all of them.
Not
like,
all?
The areas we're going to go to after, we're going to go to, like, the bad parts of Canada.
Oh, nice.
See my cousins and
yeah.
shit. Secret family. Yes, I'm going to come see you. Jesus.
Finally, it happened to me. I get to see my daddy. His name is Desus.
Little kid just counting down the days on his calendar. Yo, like,
yo. The kid come out from behind the curtain. It's a no weakness kid. He's like, blood twist. No weakness. Now we have to fight to the death.
Here we go.
No, it's like, come fuck.
Come on, little Baron.
Come on. Let's go. Let's scrap. You smash a 22 over the nigga's head like,
you're just making me stronger.
He's like, damn.
Like, his mother's like, I told you, don't get your hopes up. He's not coming. She's like, look, it's on the Just for Laughs thing.
Yo.
He bought a ticket.
Nigga bought the ticket.
I'm like, ah, fine.
Yo. Nigga's in the green room like.
I'm like, oh.
Mm-hmm.
Seven. I was like, I couldn't go, you know, the border.
Eight years, huh?
How you doing?
I read the Wikipedia, nigga. The charges were dropped.
Okay.
The charges were dropped. What's the excuse now, huh?
How school?
No. Let's start from the beginning. So how about we start from the beginning, huh? Where were you?
How did he get in this green room?
I'm your fucking son.
Victor, how did he get in the green room?
He was on
the list.
You know we don't roll with security.
I'm your son. Victor's tied up with Gorilla glue tape around his mouth like...
I'm like, how much money you want?
Nigga starts calculating Jamaican dollars like...
I'll be like, psych, you don't get nothing. What I gave you was the gift of scorn.
That's right.
Now go forth with it.
Yeah, here.
It's a gift turned down by my whole family.
Fuck out of here, take that.
This is a heirloom, we just pass it along.
Yeah.
That's what my family's golden... You know how you got the family seal?
Yeah.
It's just two snakes back to back and it just says... Anger.
Anger? Yo. Oh, shit. Oh, man. Yo.
Shout out to my Lyft driver, Ula, yesterday, who was very excited because I've had him twice.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, like the chances of having the same Lyft driver in New York twice is, like, ridiculously low.
Right.
Also, when he pulled up, before he pulled off, he was turned around and said to me, "You Gucci?"
Oh,
I was like,
shit, yeah.
Oh, God,
five stars. Five stars.
I was like, he speaks the language.
Yeah, right. Shout out to Uber Uber drivers that are like, I feel like there's never an in between. Like, you either get in with a fucking robot that hates his job, mm-hmm. or you get in with somebody that's so flowery that it makes you upset.
Chatty Patty, someone who just loves fucking. Oh my God, I love driving Uber. It's one of the greatest things ever. You get to meet people, you get to go places. Where are you going to today? What a wonderful day to drive. I mean, there's a lot of traffic, but I don't mind it. I was thinking maybe I'll add some iPads in the back and maybe a little charging station. You guys good? I got a forming grill here. I can make you a quick patini.
I'm like, yo, do you have an iPhone charger?
iPhone charger for what? The iPhone 6, the iPhone 7, the iPhone 8, the iPhone X? I'm just kidding. It's not out yet. Ordered it. I just gotta wait on it right now. I got notifications sent.
Oh my God.
This is a cool thing. When the notification comes up, it's
gonna
come on
the
dashboard
right here.
Right,
you're gonna get. You're gonna get stuck. Right, yeah, it's, we're gonna go
I'm
to
using Google Maps. I'm using Waze. Which would you prefer? I've been driving this neighborhood for a long time. Like, you know what I was thinking? If I make it left on 48th Street, I can come up on 53rd.
How fast are we going right now? 50 miles an hour?
We're doing 50 miles an hour. I just circle back around like, "Hey guy, you fell off the thing. I just came to pick you up again.
Are you okay?
You seem to have a concussion.
I hope this isn't been writing.
You know what I'm saying? Like, would you toss me around on the east side or the west side?
No, I called it.
Hey, you seem to have swelling on the brain, so before you die, I just ask you to hit open the app and hit 5 stars. Thanks.
No, I'm calling it Juno.
Hey, don't be a dick. Give me the tip. All right, you have a wonderful day. Thanks for driving Uber. Boop.
Purple tastes good.
The thing when they're mad chatty, you have to be slow to respond,
bro. That's why
I be like, "What? Oh, what you said? I was on the phone. I couldn't hear you. I wasn't paying attention to what you were saying."
The perfect move that I discovered is the
headphones,
the brolic headphones, and then you just slowly look up. Like, what'd you say? What? Oh, no, I'm sorry. I'm doing work on my phone. Yeah, I'm answering emails and stuff. I'm sorry. Yeah, no, that's fine. The air conditioning is fine. Yeah, no, the air conditioning is fine. It's 100 degrees, you idiot. Of course, I want the fucking air conditioner. Do you want the air conditioner? Would you rather have the windows down? Yo, no, I want to smell New Jersey while I drive down Route 3, my nigga. That's what I want to do.
I'm becoming a new asshole because this morning, the Lyft driver, I was. He had on the fucking sweater. I'm like, oh, my God, it's mad. It's hot in here. And I was like, he turned on AC. He just... I did that like side thing and turned on the AC.
Yeah.
And so we're sitting there, the AC's going for 5 minutes, and he still has like the front window down. And I was like, I could have been like, "Yo, could you put up the front window?"
Yeah.
But because like I'm paying for this ride, I was like, "So we're just gonna ride with the window down the whole way?" And all I heard was my mother pump her fist, like, "I've taught him well.
I've taught him well. Good."
And he was like, "Oh, I'm sorry."
Yo. Yeah, that's a good... Shout out to West Indian parents for instilling aggression in you.
Aggression.
You know what I'm saying?
Passive aggression.
You know what I'm saying?
Why should I be direct with my anger?
You know what I'm saying?
You'll find out when I'm banging stuff later.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, you didn't take the garbage out? Oh, okay. All right, let me just clean this fucking... Dusting off the shelf. These people don't want to clean this house.
Fucking
clean the house by myself.
So self, you know?
Self,
do everything.
Everything.
You'll be sorry. You'll be sorry when I'm dead.
Dead.
That is, if my mom was a My Buddy doll, that would be her only catchphrase. When I'm dead, you're going to see what it is. You're going to see what life is like when I'm dead and I'm not around to do everything. I'm like, Mom.
Come in the theaters this summer. When I'm dead, you'll see what it is. Starring the kid Mero's mother. My mother's always was like, "Oh, you don't want to eat my food?"
Mm-hmm.
when you move out, you know, come back here with a compound bucket and beg for soup.
First of all, this is from yesterday. You heated it up. I peep game. I'm not stupid. I seen you make the brolic pot last night.
But she was up here. I was like, damn. I was like, oh, yeah, I made nothing for dinner. She was like, I cooked for your father for almost 40 years. I deserve a break. I was like, nah. I was like, yo, make your food spicy, not your tongue.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I'm the man in this house. I pay the bills, lady. But she got up too fast. I was like,
chill. You said that on Lipsy. Mad fast. Like, nigga, like, oh.
I was like, yo, I was wrong. I'm sorry.
Hey, what are you feeling like? Some Chinese?
What you want the bed?
Pizza?
What you want the bed? I blocked up all the belts. I was like, nah, fuck this. I was like, nah, my watch.
I threw all my dad's disco boots into storage and shit. I'm not trying to catch one of my dad's.
She turned on the light. I had mad belts in my hand. Like, I was giving these to Hurricane Irma's victims.
Then she pulls one out the ankle holster and shit. Like, yo, fam. Oh my God.
Oh,
how niggas grown ass men scared to death of their parents?
I mean, you know, the thing, I'm scared of my mother. I'm not scared of my father because I'll throw the hands with my father. Yeah. So, like, two men enter the ring, one's gonna die kind of shit.
I'm confident in my ability to knock my dad out, but I'm not confident in my ability to take him down because the nigga did judo and he has like a belt in judo and all this shit. So I'm like, all that is like, I'm gonna grab your neck and sweep your leg and you're gonna have a concussion and pass out.
That's the thing.
Like,
you don't go to jail for that.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, definitely your father. My father has a low center of gravity, so, and he has a bad knee, so also, did you realize that Terry Crews was the guy clapping the birds in Training Day?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, when he said that, I'm a weirdo, and pictures just come in my head. Maybe I need to be analyzed. As soon as he said that, I was like, oh shit, it was. He was wild, sweaty, with no shirt on.
They never show his face. They only show his from the back.
Sitting down, right?
They're standing on the roof.
Yeah, and it's like the sun is like, and the sun is
watching. And you're gonna be like, oh shit, that is Terry Crews.
I didn't recognize his pecs.
Yeah, that's Terry Crews. But now you look at it, it changes the whole nature of the movie because when you see him doing it, you're like, that's Terry Crews. They're about to take out the glow sticks and dance and shit. They're about to do a white girl shit. Yeah, Terry Crews.
Yo, shout out to him because I feel like he's like us in that, like, yo, I did some funny style shit, but nigga, I got that check, so I'm hype. I'll talk about that shit for an hour, nigga. You want to talk about fucking Blame Me the Bear, nigga, for an hour? I'm with it. They were like, hey, Desus Mero, how are you guys doing? Bodega Boys, so great to have you on today on Ellen. Your Kotex commercial has gone viral. How does it make you feel?
I mean, when they told us we were going to dress up as tampons and then go down a red river, it sounded like a bad look. But then Victor said, the check's so big, you can slap the bank teller in the face. I said, hey, let's do it.
Let's do it, you know? And actually, you know what? To keep it extra funky, Desus and I decided that we wanted to use actual menstrual blood.
Yeah. We are thespians, and anything less would be an insult to the authenticity and our audience.
Yeah, we're like Daniel Day-Lewis, except good.
Mm-hmm. There's mad pictures of us training in a Woody and mad ragu. Like,
Yeah!
They're like, why did you choose...
Picking pads out the garbage and Target and shit, like,
why did you two choose to dress like DMX on? On There Is a Dark Side? Us back to back naked.
Mad blood!
Yeah. I'm just like, they're like, why are y'all naked? It's like, for PETA.
Yeah. Gucci, stop wearing fur! Yeah, that was the corniest display I've ever seen. We talked about it on Desus Mero, number one show, late night, Monday through Thursday, 11 p.m. Advice Land. Tune in. Stupid. Mm-hmm. If you're not, you're really behind the times and you're really fucking up.
Yeah. What are you watching?
You know what I mean? You're gonna be that guy that catches onto something after everybody already has the phrases and the graphics and the what is your rainbow?
You're gonna be the person that starts watching. What's the name of that show about the meth?
Breaking Bad.
And you started watching it season four, and you mad lost, but you're still watching it. And you're like, that's his wife.
Suck
a wife.
Dick from the what?
Who said what? Why is there a pizza on the roof? So, you know what I mean? Go ahead, be lost.
Good.
But yeah,
you know what I'm saying,
you'd
be on the wrong side of history, fam.
Yeah, we're gonna join PETA. We're gonna do like the wild ad, like, fur is death. Like, stop eating meat. And then like immediately after, they're gonna like get to the black car from the shoot. I'm gonna have the wild chopped cheese.
With a mink on, spilling mad meat on you and shit.
Just
like
a slap of ribs. While I'm wearing like a mink coat.
Fred Flintstone shit. This shit's on top of the car.
This shit's coming out the window of the SUV. Should make this shit till a turn.
Yo, hold the ribs, they're gonna fall out. Chill.
I got you, my nigga.
Yo, here, hold this brush. Keep brushing it. I got some sauce.
He's got a smoker in the back. They'll be like, no, Victor, you gotta get back the check. Like, the money's spent, baby. Victor, get back like a check stub. You got the wild.
You got your man for the you got your man for the jerk spot hooked onto the back of the truck, riding the smoker, like, yo, yeah,
good to go. They call Victor on FaceTime. Victor got the wild, the fucking bib, yo, the fucking bone on it. Mad sneaker, like eating it, like. Like, what? Like, oh, you're talking meats? Talking big meats,
baby? Oh, all right.
Yeah. They're like, how y'all? We just signed, he's like, oh, jokes on you. We just signed a deal with Lowry's.
Yeah, fuck
like,
that.
Nigga, still Lowry's. How y'all just did PETA on Monday? Y'all signed a Lowry's.
It's us and Salt Bay rubbing down ribs, like, oh, yeah, Lowry's.
Just rubbing down a straight up cow. Lowry's. Cow still alive.
The cow still alive, like, what are you doing?
The top says cow still alive, but the bottom says not too long.
I mean, Salt Bay comes out with the wild Turkish knife and shit, like, yo.
The blood squirts on the camera and spills out. Lowry's. It's what seasoning.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Yo.
Peter was like, well, we were going to get them, but.
Listen, y'all not gonna do us. Y'all got Waka Flocka naked. We are not doing that type of shit.
Yeah, come on, man.
Fuck out of here. Yeah, whatever. Like, killing animals is bad. Don't abuse your pets. You know, golden rule, all of that. I'm not standing naked covering my dick with one hand.
What's the minimum number you need for that? For nudity in the scene.
What's 3 million after taxes? 1.5?
Just why are you after taxes? They could just say them out.
It needs to be at least.
Who's like, yo, how much money would you need to be rich? Like, how much is 150 million after taxes?
I'm just saying, like, I need to know this because
when
I'm
kids are on the playground and shit. When you're like, yo, hit the final shot, and he goes like final shot to win the finals. No one's like final shot to win game two of the Eastern Conference Finals.
Hey,
like, no.
Hey, I'm a Knicks fan. That's triggering. Niggas celebrating
like regular.
We celebrate. Nigga, I lifted a trophy for a preseason game.
Damn.
You know what I'm saying?
Remember when they dropped balloons at the Garden?
Yep.
When they won a game in the first fucking round.
Yes, they did.
And the balloons were dusty.
Balloons and confetti.
Everyone that had used air in their lungs to blow up those balloons was dead.
Already.
That's how long they had been up there.
Already. You could put them shits on eBay, nigga. It's a Great Depression air.
They were blowing up. They was like, I really hope we win World War One.
I hope so. Well, man, blowing up these balloons is so hard when you got black lung.
Hey, turn on that's my favorite song. 23 Skidoo.
23 Skidoo.
Right into my boy in the Bugles.
Skidoo down.
Hey, you know what? We had a bad season last year, but I really hope the 1915 Knicks win it.
I really like Dolph Schayes.
There's no way they can go that long without winning. Oh, well, let's go. I mean, so I heard a funny joke the other day. He said next time the Knicks win, there's going to be niggas on the court. Pass the cigar, Lumpy.
Man, Shane. Fucking Nucky Thompson is a fucking James Dolan.
We went to like 5 accents in that little exchange. We're terrible. Why are we popular?
Oh, God.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, well, you know, the Knicks
somebody
are shambles.
Like, someone's like, damn, green light that.
Yeah, totally.
They're going to do Boardwalk Empire meets the Homeland meets the Knicks.
James Dolan.
He's been like, cut the check.
James Dolan's Nucky Thompson. He's like, I want to speak to you all today regarding the future of the franchise, but first. Nigga wheels out an acoustic guitar. You're like, oh, no, no.
Not even acoustic guitar, but those, like, the fucking turntables with the big horn. You gotta crank it. I got some new tunes for you guys.
It's JD and Strange Arts. We're out here ruining franchises.
Save a tin can for your man over in Japan.
Damn.
Like, goddamn.
Fuck. This is eternal. I feel like I keep asked this every single day. How old is this guy, bro? Like, ooh. How long do we have to wait?
He's not going. He's rich.
Is he 60 something at least?
I think he's in his late 50s. Yeah, he's young.
Oh, fuck.
He's 62. He's 62.
Damn.
You know what his net worth is?
A fucking $1 billion.
$1.5 billion.
God.
He's cool. He's listening like, yeah, get it fucking right, Mero.
Fuck.
Matter of fact, I'm gonna buy some more kazoos tonight. More kazoos for your dome piece. Watch how you speak on my name.
Watch it. Fucking more embarrassment for your dome piece.
Matter of fact, he's gonna buy Viceland. He's gonna be like, yeah, you know what? I even like Viceland. I want Desus and Mero to come out here and play kazoos with me.
That's
and
right.
I'll be like, Mero, Victor, this is our contract. We don't have to do that, right?
I get a FaceTime from my kids, and I'm just like,
he's like, yo. Excuse me. Count of three. One, two, three. Mr. Dolan, my kazoo is broken. He's like, that's going to come out your pocket. I got paid for a bottle kazoo.
I'm just talking to the mic like, I wish I was dead. He's like, no vocals. I'm the vocalist.
All right. Now, remember, thank you, everyone, for coming here. I was moved by Beyonce. She remixed a popular song to Hurricane Relief. So this is JD and the Sure Shots featuring the Bodega Boys. We're going to play the kazoo version of J Balvin's Mi Gente.
Yeah, let's go.
I need a C flat, guys. You know what? If you guys don't want to take this seriously, we'll start over.
Man, make Amari do the show. Oh, he don't even play for us no more. Damn. Oh,
fucking Beasley is over there. All right.
Sir,
that's not a kazoo.
Sir, you don't inhale a kazoo.
He's like,
nigga, trying to light the kazoo. Yeah, nigga, put the fucking weed in the top of the kazoo, trying to light it like a bowl. Like, he's like, hey, Jay, my shit melting. Why my shit melting? How you gave me a bowl that's plastic, nigga?
Oh, shit.
I thought this shit was silicone.
Chris Apps is like, I'm off this. This
I am off this. This is ridiculous.
I'm skipping this at my exit interview.
I'm going back to Latvia.
Oh, lordy.
Lordy, lordy, smoky beans.
Any new Jew holidays coming up? Anything new in the Jew letter? The new Jew letter that you can tell us about?
Rosh Hashanah.
You guys got any new dreidels on the way?
Hanukkah. I got some new exclusive shit. Been working with Nike, mm-hmm. using dry fit technology to have,
Niggas got the dreidel with the fly knit.
Yeah. Oh, flying the dreidels, bro. We lit out here, bro. And it has a compartment that holds your, you know what I'm saying, your gelt in it. You know what
Damn,
I'm saying?
Nigga.
So if you want to do it in style, Nike dreidel.
We gotta
swoosh.
We have enough time to like release a limited edition Bodega Boys dreidel.
I mean, yeah, dreidel. I feel like anything is possible if you're in cahoots with China.
I couldn't remember how to spell dreidel, so I put in spinny. It's a Google. I put in spinny Jew thing.
Spinny Jew thing. I feel like if you get like
also, we have the results of our scientific experiment.
Okay,
apparently seal is more popping.
Yes.
Than seals.
The actual seals.
Yes.
Yep.
According to our Google results, It's not about Google being racist, even though there are a couple of people who got pictures of seals instead
with
of
seal.
Picture of Seal the singer.
Have you seen the picture that's a seal with Seal's head on it?
Yes.
That pops up so much, too.
You know.
So is that a push? Like, I don't know.
It's a push, yeah.
It's a push?
Google's still racist, though.
Yeah, it
Google's
is.
Still racist.
Yeah,
so there's a special Google for white people and a special Google for black people.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Just want you people to know.
Oh, yeah.
There's one where they're like, we put a number one song. It says Taylor Swift. For us, it says Bodak Yellow. The two shall never meet.
Ah.
Okay?
I can't.
I've heard Taylor Swift's song once in my entire life. I heard it in a lift and I was like, what is this audio monstrosity?
What is this?
This song is garbage.
That makes me feel like it doesn't even make me feel washed. It just makes me feel like I might be an alien or some shit.
Yeah.
Because the shit does not sound good to me at all. Like, there's no, it's not like, yo, that was a dope guitar solo, or like, yo, that was a good vote. I'm just like, nigga, this shit is Forever 21 bathroom music. Like, this shit sucks, bro.
Not trying to get jiggy with that shit. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's also, you get to that point, you're just, OD, like, nah.
No, I'm good.
I got enough new songs. Like, there's like, yo, here's 20 new songs you didn't hear. I was like, nah.
I don't got.
There's a lot of work. Like, I got, it's not like it used to be.
Yeah.
And now I sound like an old watch nigga, because I'm like, yo, used to be able to pronounce art. Like, yo, I don't know how to pronounce it.
I don't even know how to say. I don't even know how to say, yo, what song is this to somebody?
Yeah.
And they'd be like, yo, it's
It's like, oh, it's I'm like, oh, I love this song by Six Black. They're like, no, it's just Black.
It's
I was like,
black.
What?
The, why oh, just, the six is a the six is a
I
B?
I was like, why don't you just write the shit as Black? What the fuck?
What? Like, bruh.
A little pump.
You're typing six into fucking thing?
No, that's when you start typing like your parents. Like you lift your glasses, you're like, ah. Type one finger like
shift.
Six.
Listen, if I have to press the shift key to find you on any streaming service, I'm not listening to your music.
Turn Matt Walsh, you just type in random words into Google.
Yeah.
It's like song goes ooh, ooh.
Ooh, ooh, lyrics.
Ooh, ooh.
Pump. Just mad, mad.
Just like,
it's like a fucking Trump speech.
It's like, song about Rari possible
ASAP. Gucci Gang goes off, though. Holy shit.
Gucci, Google, what's the name of the song that goes Gucci Gang, Gucci Gang, Gang, Gucci Gang, Gang, Gucci Gang, Gucci Gang.
My bitch love do cocaine.
Google's like, I can't tell you this. You're too washed.
Try Bing.
Fucking Bing. Bing's like, nah, I'm not telling you.
Yeah, Bing's for wings.
Bing is like, hey, welcome.
Hi.
Thanks for using me as a search.
Oh my God.
Before you do a search, can I just ask you, can I become your default search engine?
Can I please?
We can be best buds. Let's go. I'll go to your notifications. Just check this box here.
Yeah, please.
We're best buds for life.
Forever.
Hey, I'm Bing.
Hey.
Bing and Mero, hey, listen. Hey, I know you like Google, but this is kind of saying results.
Do you want me to save your home address and everything else in your world?
Let's go.
Hey, do you want me to upload to your contacts?
Hey, you're looking for Gucci Gang? Okay, I can show you gangs, and I can show you the local Gucci store.
Yeah.
I can show you Gucci Man.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Don't close the browser window.
Look.
Best friend forever.
You want a Crips, right? This is a Crips.
Hey, where you going? Come on. Wait. Log in with your Hotmail address.
Please, come on.
Friend
said Hotmail.
I forgot about that. Yeah. Excuse me. Your MSN Live.
Oh, shit.
Because they've combined them. It's also Skynet. And
Skynet.
Yo, you know who's trash?
Pure,
Xbox Live.
Pure Babylon.
Because when you try to log in with like a Gmail address, they're like, excuse you?
Oh, what?
They're like, what is that?
Who did Yahoo buy? Did Yahoo buy somebody or did somebody buy Yahoo?
Yahoo bought Rocket Mail.
Okay.
Which was a very popping kind of popped. Okay. Because
when I first got on Xbox Live, I was... It was washed era, and I used the Yahoo email, so I'm nervous.
Yeah.
I don't know about it.
No, they act funny about the Gmail one. They're like, no, you got to use, like, either Hotmail or that Live. And they're like, oh, you don't have one? We'll make you one.
Make you one right now.
I'm
go
like,
ahead.
I don't think I've ever logged into this shit. I don't, you know, it's a straight Babylon thing. I don't trust none of that stuff.
No.
Why I need so many Hotmail accounts?
Why? Shit's getting hot.
Father and my parents, they both have, like, they still have, like,
the at me shits, or whatever,
and they'd be like, "Yo, why you sent me a virus?" I'm like, "What?
I didn't send you shit."
And they show me, and it'd be straight up like, "From Desus, nice greeting card, hello." And I'm like, "Nigga,
that's spam."
My email account, desusnice@latvia.ru. Like, why would you open this?
Like,
but Yahoo's just like, "Yo, Yahoo tell you got a spam after the fact." They'd be like, "Yo, fam, yo, damn, you shouldn't have opened that."
I thought you knew.
Like, why are you getting email from people you don't know?
Come on, B. Like, you should be.
If anything, like, you burned me.
Yahoo fucking customer service will call you and be like, yo, my nigga, listen, honestly, if you knew better, you do better.
Yeah.
Click.
They'd be like, yo, this message is for the kid Mero. Yo, you might want to go get your email tested. I'm sorry, bye.
My bad.
You'd be like, oh, shit.
What? Yeah, the clinic and shit. Like,
this nigga put a war on my inbox.
You call the nigga back. He's like, yeah, I burnt you, nigga. Ha ha, stupid.
I'm like, oh, you gave my email gonorrhea.
Fuck.
Stupid bitch, I'm gonna find you.
I'm gonna find you.
I'm gonna use LinkedIn.
Yeah. Oh,
is there a service where you could, like, contact people to let them know that you burned them?
There should be.
There should be, like, an app, and it's just be like, yo.
Burner.
Give me access to all your contacts. I just do it out of one mass thing, and it sends like a bitmoji, like, roses are red, violets are blue. You need to get tested because I'm going to give you something back. And at the end, it's like, hey, you thought that was going to rhyme, right?
Hey, click
everything
link.
Doesn't end well.
No,
so
sorry.
Go get tested. So your story's not like that. Bye. What's it called? You said it's called Burner?
Burner. Go take a pill, man. Or pa. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Gender fluid.
Gender fluid. That's just mean, though.
You know what I'm saying?
That's just mean. You can't be doing that. We got to create an app, though, for something. Because people get money from making apps.
Yo, low-key, a dope app delivery would be like, yo, I'll bring you a Plan B pill to your crib.
That's not how Plan B works. You
smash raw, and then you want to roll around the next morning and shit, and then just bring the pill. You don't got to get up and take your walk to Dwayne Reed or whoever the fuck and be like, yo, I need
a
Plan B.
We're driving around like a PT Cooper's with like the service. The person just has like one... Plan B, like they run and just drop it to you.
I was thinking about it, and I was like, we could multitask it. We could get one of the little Red Bull cars and give people Red Bull and also Plan B pills. Because like, yo, you probably gonna want to keep smashing again this early. Drink a Red Bull, take your Plan B. You know what I'm saying? Then you could roll dog all day, and nobody buys just one Plan B. You know what I'm saying?
You have no idea how a Plan B pill works, do you?
I mean,
no, you have none. No, sick over here thinks that's just a tic tac.
You know what I mean? You just take it the next day.
Oh my god!
So
they just take it and just keep smashing raw all day. That shit is not like
so. To me, what Plan B is you fuck raw, you don't know what happened, like, yo, this thing might have nutted to me, I'm not sure, whatever. You go to the store, you get your Plan B, you take your Plan B, and if there's something going on in there, gets it out of there. That's essentially plan B. Is
essentially.
Yeah.
It's a little more complicated.
It's a little
more
complex. You know what I'm saying?
It's a little more than that, but you know what I'm saying? God's working for all of us. Actually, it's not actually called Plan B. It's just called Plan.
Plan?
But it's just because we're from New York. We always be like, yo, Plan B.
The Plan B, nigga.
Yo, Ma, you got to get the Plan B.
Come on, stop playing with that shit, yo. Deadass. You know what Plan B I'm not trying to have, my baby, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just started getting to this money. You know what I mean? I got studio time tonight.
She sent you the text of a little baby emoji, like,
well,
the hands up.
And yo.
The hands up in the air, like, what we going to do?
What's up?
What's up?
I'm like, God damn.
You're like, damn, I'll be like, damn, I got to take this little nigga to Jimmy Jazz.
I'd be like, damn, you'd be a great mom.
I mean, some women you get, like, yeah, you're like, yo, she'd be an amazing mother. And other would be like,
your grandma's gonna be an amazing mom.
It's like, yo, you know how Pussy and Cocky made the perfect team? Me and you. No,
that was a battle.
Our shit's not working out well. What's happening? Like, you can't cook, I don't eat food.
Yes.
Baby, can't raise a baby on Seamless. You actually can if you have enough money.
I mean, if you're rich, but.
Baby, just have like the mad.
Imagine you raise a baby with a personal chef and he just becomes a wild prick. You can't take him to the food court no more and shit.
Cannot wait. The Desus baby's gonna wear little ascots. Asshole.
Amazing. I'm definitely gonna smash him. I'm gonna smash some Chick-fil-A after this.
Oh,
I just got the urge.
Thanks to smash some Chick-fil-A. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You got two Chick-fil-A's in New York. You know what I'm saying? You can make some. Go in there. Ask for it without a Bible verse.
Yeah, please.
You know.
Oh, it's Friday. Oh, they're good. We're good. It's Friday. Yeah.
Yeah, they only close on Sunday.
Yeah.
Which is stupid.
I mean, like, yeah.
You losing money for God? Like, God didn't tell you to lose money.
Is God hitting you off? Like, yo, I got you money. I got you on a 20% subsidy on your taxes. Like, you'd be good. You know what I mean? Don't worry about it.
Yeah, but you know.
Whatever. You know what I'm saying?
It's like.
If the chicken wasn't so good, I would be more upset about it or whatever, but.
Yeah, Chick-fil-A is one of those. Chick-fil-A is a problematic. Chick-fil-A is the Chris Brown of music.
It is.
I mean, the Chris Brown chicken.
Of chicken. It really is. They do
like,
problematic things.
We know it's not good. We know it's not good. You know, it does some stuff we can't support. But guess what? Niggas, it does that front flip into your mouth.
Oh,
like, yeah.
Oh, man.
Breezy.
When they're like, yo, you want to add cheese to that? And then when you be like, yo, let me get a 50-50 with that?
Ooh.
Oh, man. Them niggas getting it in over there.
You know, Chris Brown is going to be on a Tom Joyner tour cruise.
What?
Yes.
Is he washed?
He's been around for a minute. So, yeah.
What's his net worth? I hope it's at least 100 something million.
Net worth?
Yeah.
He's got to be at.
I feel like he's a
like
tragic.
30 mil?
I feel like he's a tragic figure, B. Even though he did the unforgivable act of striking a woman.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's something going on with him, B. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel bad.
He has anger issues and shit.
Yeah.
I mean, you know
like,
I mean?
Fam, go to therapy. Seek help.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We all do it. It's not, there's no shame in that.
But then he's like, you can't, it's hard to tell niggas that are popping to get therapy because in their head, they're like, yo, the shit I'm dealing with is because I'm popping.
Right.
It's not therapy.
It's not
shit.
Me.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's like, it's me reacting to a new situation
right,
I'm
right,
putting
right.
into, and anyone
right.
from my background put into that situation
right.
would react the same way. So.
I mean, that's the thing too. Like, you gotta find a good therapist. Like, if you go into it with that mindset, like your therapist is supposed to help you get out of that mindset. Like, yo, listen, you're Chris Brown. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're not. You know what I'm saying? You are breezy for all intents and purposes.
I'm
but
breezy.
Right here in this chair,
but trust me, it's breezy.
Okay, well, listen. What I want you to understand is this.
But trust me, it's breezy. Don't look at me. I have sunglasses on.
Christopher, please.
I'm breezy.
Christopher, your insurance card.
Niggas are
dancing around. Jumping over the chains
I'm
and shit.
Breezy.
Like, please sit down. Just please sit down.
I'm
please
breezy.
Sit down. It's okay. Let it out.
I'm breezy.
Let it out. Let
I'm
it
breezy.
Out.
Ooh.
Is physical contact
Ooh.
Okay? Do you
no.
want a hug?
Pop locking and shit. Like, stay away from me.
Okay.
Stay away from me.
Okay.
I
just
got an
let's just relax.
My heart used
let's
to
just
be.
Relax. She has the orderly button and shit. Like, come bring this thing some
Xanax. Grab me as I'm trying to really
rock.
Like, get off me.
Yo. Oh, shit.
I'll forever be breezy.
Help me. Breezy, I don't know. But
he'll be okay.
But he'll be all right. And Rihanna's flourishing. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Fendi. Shout out to that whack-ass makeup company that tried to come for her and be like, oh, we've been had all shades for all shades of women. Like, bitch, shut the fuck up. Stop trying to throw shade at Riri. Let her shine. You know what I'm saying? She is a non-problematic figure. She smokes good weed. You know what I'm saying? And I respect her. As a West Indian man,
shout out to her, using her platform to
for
help
good.
The hurricane people.
Yo, when
and
the
making
when she,
Fenty makeup,
you know what I'm saying? And yo, when she's using her platform to highlight, like, yo, look at what's in the news.
know what I'm saying? That's commendable. So shout out to Riri.
Shout out to her.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Rita Ora. She's sending money for the hurricane.
Okay. To Albania?
I just made that up.
We'll know her hurricane. Is she sending money to Lydig Avenue and shit?
Actually, no. She got hands-on for hurricane relief in Dallas.
Oh, shit. Okay. All right.
Look at me.
Shout out to Rita.
I'm slandering Rita Ora.
Shout out to you.
Out here. She's working.
I love that song that you did.
The song that goes, I'm Rita Ora. Sounds about real.
Yeah.
What do you, what? Breaking news,
who died?
Y'all.
Who died?
The Trail Spreewell said, I am totally overwhelmed with fans of my spinner shoes coming back in 2018. Can't wait to share more details soon.
What? We getting the sprees back?
We're riding spinners. We're riding spinners.
They don't stop.
We're riding spinners.
They don't stop.
Oh, y'all don't know.
Yo, first commercial has to be Crunchy Black doing the Crunchy Black dance in Dada spinners. Are these gonna be Dada? We have very limited info.
Got to. We're gonna have a special pair. We're gonna work with the Charles Brewells. The special. They're gonna have the tongue of him choking PJ Callisto.
Son,
look at all you whack niggas outside right now. Look down your feet. You standing still? Are your shoes still moving though?
Nope. Not at all.
Y'all know about that. You pull up to a shorty at the crosswalk and shit. She looked down. She's like, are those rims on your sneakers?
Are they still spinning?
I'm like, they still spinning.
Yeah, man. Oh, make a special Bronx edition, you know what I'm saying? Where the wheels are just bus wheels.
No.
You know what I'm saying? And they keep spinning.
Hurricane Harvey relief, and it's the Puerto Rican flag. And it's just spinning. Nice.
Nice.
Nice. Got the big pun of Jordan.
Yeah, the air pun joint. Yeah.
Spinner shoes.
Yeah.
That's it. I mean, spinner shoes is cool and stuff.
I want to just answer. I feel like maybe give me some insight into this. Who is clamoring for these?
Watch as I raise my hands. Okay. Y'all know about that.
Yeah.
They're dangerous, though, because, you know, like, they just be spinning in like a full minute.
Can you even open those? I never.
Nigga, they spinning rims. No, you can't hoop in them. This shit is like 13 pounds. You got metal attached for no reason.
They're real metal?
It's like a light metal.
Oh, okay.
I mean, for the first couple of wears you wear them, like, they spin, no problem. But then after a while, like,
you gotta oil them shit up?
This shit feels like clippers. It's like a bevel blade. You gotta make sure that shit don't rust up and shit.
Niggas at Foot Locker like, yo, let me get the shoe cleaner and do y'all got WD-40?
Yo, y'all got the heavy lube? Cause I'm saying there's like some, you gotta take that shit to the mechanic, nigga, lift that shit. He's like, oh, I see what the problem is. You got a problem with your spinning gasket.
That's what's happening.
I see what happens, a little moisture gets in there. You see like the vapor seal right there? Put your finger in it right there. Look at all that. That right there is rotted.
Uh-huh.
You gotta take that out right there.
Yeah, so
that's why you're spinning. It's not spinning. That's why it spins a little and it stops.
Okay, so how much is it gonna cost me there?
Man. Is it out of pocket or you going through insurance?
I got a pack of Newport right now.
Okay, well, it's gonna take me. I gotta order the parts first.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I don't even know if they still make these
damn,
parts.
Damn.
Oof. Look at that. Look at all that rot. Look at that. Put your finger in there.
I mean, I trust you.
Go down. Put your finger in there. Feel all that rot. Feel that part that's moist right there?
Yeah,
that's on me.
Oh. What part are you?
The down part.
That's nasty. Nigga jerking over to the dad ass niggas. That's when the niggas they lubricate.
He's like, yeah, now it's really spinning, nigga. I'll show you a spin.
Nigga spins, it's just splashing your face. You're like, ew. Bodily fluids.
Oh, man. But yeah, spinning rims. So if that could come back, what else we gotta bring back? We gotta definitely bring back the
2-tone Durex.
Bring those back. They never left.
Wearing a paper towel as a bandana.
That's not that efficient. You can't go green with that. Like, if people just see you wasting bandanas, like, you could barely get napkins as it is.
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
We have to. What's retro that people don't know about? We could bring back and act like we invent. You know what? We're gonna bring back 2-way pagers.
Oh,
fuck that.
Yeah.
With the ringtones and shit. Yeah.
Oh shit. Yeah, and I listen to the 2-way alert. Mm-hmm. Uh huh.
You know about that?
Damn.
Listen, when I pull out the wild sky pager, shit,
Nigga come out the star tag, flip the shit open, like, yo,
niggas go,
come on,
I'll be like, oh shit, I'll be like, yo, just talking to people, I'll be like, oh shit, my nigga Mero,
oh shit, gangster,
I gotta go, text my man,
yeah, I'm gonna hit the second bite.
The ironic shit about this song is that my man's name is Cadillac Ty, and I'm probably certain that he works at a Cadillac dealership right now.
Don't get run up by Cadillac Ty. You gotta watch how you talk to how you talk about old rappers, because they listen.
They listen.
They listen. We talked spicy about some old rappers. They got they feelings, you know what I'm saying? Niggas got time. That's what I'm saying. Niggas got time. We got time, but we don't want to have to use our time to deal with your time. You know what I'm saying? So you know what I'm saying? Keep Cindy Lauper time after time. You know what I'm saying? That's keep all. your time, so none of us have to do time. That's all I'm just
that's
saying.
That's it.
That's all I'm saying.
That's it.
Have you noticed since I got money, I'm starting to talk like an uptown nigga?
Yeah,
talking
that's
faster,
it.
Baby. Move hey, my baby. Hands, baby. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, baby, you know what it is. Come
I
on,
count
baby.
That money don't count me. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
I chase that money. I never chase women because you know what? You can chase the women. You can chase the money.
Hey.
You never chase the women because chase the money. The money's always going to be there.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Money ain't going to leave you. Money don't love you. Money, you love the money. You know what I'm saying?
I talk faster. You're going to have to listen slow.
You know what I mean?
All right now?
You in the dig what I'm saying?
Okay. I talk fast because I get money fast. You listen slow because you get money slow. So if you listen faster, you get money faster. But I can't tell you that because you're the bastard. Now look at me, King. You didn't know your father. You seen him work.
You know what I mean? Understand
work,
that.
Work.
The working man is a sucker, brother. Let me tell you something. I've been everywhere, all across the United States. I've been to the motherfucking Pineapple, the motherfucking Big Apple. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying? The motherfucking Rotten Apple. Mm-hmm. So I know what I do. You know what I'm saying? And when I see a little shorty in the street and I know what time it is, you know what I do? I get the pimping, pimping.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying?
Ain't no pimping on the simping.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Ben Carson could have been a pimp.
Yo.
Matter of fact.
He has a pimp voice. Like, I could definitely see him being like, Candy, you're working the track tonight. You're my number one bottom bitch. You know what I'm saying? I know you get it in, and you're going to make daddy proud. Bring me back all my motherfucking money.
Like, Ben Carson don't even got to smack people.
Nah.
Just
he's
talk
a,
to you. Like,
just talk. He's like, baby, I don't got to
like,
tell
hey,
you.
Hey, Ben, I'm sorry. I'm a little light tonight.
Oh, word?
I'm a little light on my money tonight.
Baby girl, let me ask you one question.
Yeah.
Do you know what they say about my hands?
What do they say, Daddy?
They are gifted. Do you understand what I'm saying? They are gifted, Ma. So what I need you to do is go back out there and get that light heavy. You understand? And come back and bring Daddy his money. That's all I got to say. You are dismissed. Candy, come over here. Put your titty in my mouth.
The Chronicles of Ben Carson.
Think of the wild white brunette. They got the future hat on with the feathers sticking up. Blaxploitation Ben Carson would have been the fucking worst. Yo, I look back at a lot of old shit and I'm like, wow.
This is Blaxploitation. Wow. It was wilding out there.
I was, yeah. Shout out to the Mac, though.
The who?
The Mac.
Oh, the Mac.
Max Julian.
I thought you were going to say The Wiz. Because, you know, they say nobody beats The Wiz.
Oh, yeah. Oh shit. Nobody beats The Wiz. Nobody beats The Wiz.
Damn. Everybody electronics. Yeah.
I used to boost so crazy from The Wiz on Fordham. Like, they did not care. Like, everybody that worked there was a beautiful Puerto Rican woman. And they did not care that you stole anything.
Because that's when people didn't care about shit like that.
Yeah.
But now, niggas be like, yo. You see all these mints at Rite Aid? When you see them, you see me. So if you steal a mint, you steal it from me.
Mm-hmm.
And my pockets ain't gonna be light.
Mm-mm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-mm.
Nigga chase you two blocks for like a fucking thing of Neosporin. Come on, nigga. Let me boost in peace.
Dog, I remember boosting at fucking a Rite Aid on Bure off the 6. Because, like, you know what I'm saying? You know when you boost, you don't want to boost near your house. That's stupid. You know what I mean? You want to go boost somewhere else, out of state. And then go to the bumpy, get your money, whatever. So I'm at Rite Aid boosting. I'm just throwing up like hair gel, shit like that you could go to bump off to Dominican salons. I'm throwing them shits up to sleep, bam, 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 whatever, whatever. I walk out. I ring off. The security guard dead stands in front of the door and does like an X formation. And there's an old lady on his right-hand side. And on his left-hand side, there's like a little tiny bit of space. This nigga pushed the old lady out the way to try to block me out the door, and I just gave your man the shove of life, fam, that he was not expecting, and I ran the fuck out of there, man. And I never went back there to boost again. But I G'd off. I made like $120 in hair gels. You know what I'm saying? Light work.
Agent Johnson is writing all this stuff, and he's like, "Yo, this nigga's $800 away from it being a felony."
I can't wait for some old shit to pop up. I kept my nose clean. I continue to keep my nose clean. I feel like there's a statute of limitations on certain things.
I'm sure one of us confessed to some crime and like it's gonna come back to haunt us on this podcast.
That'd be crazy, bro. I just pull up and I'm like, yo, what's Desus? I have no idea. I haven't been calling him all day. I don't know.
Episode Desus versus Mero episode 7. Oh, remember when I fought?
Yeah.
Oh shit. Hey. Yeah. Hey, we're just having a good time. Yeah, hey, yeah. Just shaking and jaking. Hey, huh. Just a couple of corner boys, just enjoying the fun.
But you know what the crazy shit is? And I fully totally believe this. People don't care about this because we're Bronx people.
Yeah, nobody cares.
Like nobody cares.
We're gonna do
anything that we've done and gotten in trouble for, there's 150 cases of it happening and niggas don't even care.
We're gonna do a Broadway play, like in the Heights, but it's good. Yeah. In the Bronx. In the Bronx. Like, that's like the main thing. Like nobody cares about us. We are Bronx people. And like everyone that works, everyone on
set.
We
all hold hands and shit. Like, yeah, we are like people too.
The bodega owners, yep. And like the
multi ethnic and shit.
The fucking dope fiend and shit, yeah. Comes together.
Niggas leaning that hard and shit.
We are the Bronx.
We are the Bronx.
We live uptown, so here's another way that you avoid us. And Cardi B comes out. There's our choice, man.
And y'all niggas always go back to Connecticut right after the Yankee game. I'm like, Cardi, that's not the words. That's not the words.
Why are you doing something? I'm ad-libbing. You doing some Barty gang shit. Like, the fuck?
Nah, we out here. Like, I'm number one Billboard chart. Y'all niggas can't tell me shit.
They got us here in the headphones and mic. We're like, it's a choice. We're making the stars broken rich.
We gotta smoke the gas only. Come on. Nigga might come back with the daddy shit like, protect the Bronx. Come on.
We're standing next to Mike Francesa and shit.
He's like, I need the Bronx. I need the Yankees. I need Steve to bring me another fucking Diet Coke, please. Hey, we got John from Long Island.
It's my first and my last time. I'd like to trade Andrew Judge for Mike Tyson straight up. Hang on and listen.
That's an awful trade because Aaron Judge is probably white. And you know how I feel about the coloreds. See me at Stu Leonard's buying Malbec.
We have to be the two biggest black fans of Mike Francesa. No, we are the only reason. There's a whole demographic of people that know of this man only because of us.
Because of us!
And he has no idea who we are. It's not flattering that we know him. It's just we know of him.
I knew it wasn't flattering to be Mike Francesa when we read up on dude, and we're like, yo, we thought you were Mike Francesa. And he's like, and he turns around to his wife or whatever, was like, yo, these guys are trying to play me. They think I'm some fat radio guy. I was like, damn, that's what you think of Mike? Damn. Fat radio guy?
I always thought like as a white guy, Mike Francesa was like the epitome of cool, but no, man.
Nah. He's the epitome of like washed uncle. Not even washed dad, because like he's like your uncle that maybe had one kid and like disappeared.
What do you call it? Wash dad. Because you know what? You think he played sports and he just yells about sports.
Yeah.
That's when people say hurtful things about teachers, like, yo, those who can't do, those who can't teach. Mm-hmm. And that's like not true. But those who can't, like to talk about it. Not to say that everyone talks about sports is like that. You have people who actually know what they're talking about, but you also have some people who's just like,
You know what I'm saying? And you know what's funny? Everybody knows who the new class is. You know what I'm saying? Of people who talk about sports and incorporate like real shit into it. You know what I mean? Like, you know, Jemel Hill, Mike Smith, Pablo Torre, Bomani Jones, you know what I'm saying? My man Amina Hassan, my man Big Watts, you know what I'm saying? These are people that are coming up and are the future of sports journalism. So pay close attention, you fools. That's all I have to say about that.
Thank you. You made everyone claro.
You know what I'm saying? Make all you motherfuckers claro.
I mean, you got to make the people claro. If you don't make people claro, people be confuso.
That's true. They be confundido with me.
See?
You know what I'm saying? And then how you look, like you have fucking cucaracha en tu cabeza.
Shout out to our man Jonathan EPO out here cooking up.
Pio la tingancia.
Working on everything.
What's his actual? I want to pick up his hookah store. It's like 4387 Broadway, some shit like that.
You know what? It's a hookah store in Uptown. Yeah. Just go to any hookah store uptown,
yeah,
and he'll probably walk in.
Yo, go to Mama Sushi.
How he owns a hookah store, he also smokes copious amounts of hookah.
Yeah. He smokes that fruity shit, though. I don't know hookah classifications.
Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure fruity shit is not the actual name of it, but continue. Just like a hookah connoisseur, like somewhere like
that's what I'm saying.
That monocle dropped out there.
I feel like asking Hasan just because he got the Deacon hat on. I'm like, yo, do you know everything about hookah? Because there's like the tobacco shit, and mm-hmm. then there's like the fruity, like gel looking shit. I don't know which one is the worst.
They have the International Hookah Sommelier Academy in Uptown. You never seen that? And they have like the people and they're blindfolded.
Yeah.
And then you blow out the hookah smoke in their face. And like, I believe that's a blueberry kush with a detect a slight undercurrent of a boysenberry.
This one is good. It tastes, I feel a little bit strawberry, a little bit carbon monoxide, and a little bit platano peels.
You're like, oh, this is a trick one. Watch.
He's a masterful. We're watching a master at work.
This
right
is
now.
Peanut butter, mofongo, and
he got it, ladies and gentlemen.
Wait.
If he gets the last one, he is a genius.
And cilantro.
My God.
You can take off the blindfold and slams it on the table.
Unbelievable.
His hand in the air.
We have never seen a display like this. The announcer guy is like a golf nigga, massive dude. We've never seen a display like this. This is incredible. Ladies and gentlemen, you will never see a moment like this in hookah sports.
Amazing hookah pugilism. Just to see his concentration, just to see the amount of stability. He is the Steph Curry of hookah.
He is just incredible.
Just to watch, it's an honor to watch him on. Now we watch him to putting on the classic green hookah smoker jacket.
Unbelievable.
Wow.
What a moment in sports.
Okay, yes.
The hookah sports.
He's coming to the table with his both his families. You were at the La Marina Invitational Hookah Challenges.
Oh, the guy's like mad tight. He's walking around like he's in the corner, getting his eye cut open by his corner person. Like,
stay in a fight, nigga.
He's pressing a cold on the shit. Like, I gotta cauterize the wound.
Hey, listen. Yo, listen. He's going with the traditional hookah smoke right now. I need you to counter with some body blows.
Niggas hits homie with the hose. It's Mills Lane. Hey, guys, you gotta stop. That's illegal use of the hose. Illegal use of the hose. Hose that goes back in the corner. Let's get it on.
Oh, man. They're having a wild press conference. It's like, he can't tell the difference about the hookah.
Papi, I invented the fucking hookah. Fuck you.
Who's this fucking guy?
Listen to me, motherfucker. I'm going to take you July 29th. We're going to see who's the master of the fucking hookah, mama.
And for all my black ladies, I like fried chicken hookah, too.
This asshole is an asshole. I'm going to beat him up for everybody.
This guy here, he might be here for DACA, but his hookah skills are caca.
Guess what? I'm here from DACA, and I'm going to whoop you ass out. Motherfucker, stay with me. Fuck out of here.
Don King is like, this is going to be a hell of a fight.
The snooker and the hooker. Only in America, y'all. Only in America.
Nigga waving rhinestone flags.
Oh, shit.
God, what a piece of shit.
Oh, listen, we can make that happen. Just make hookah great again.
No, no.
Oh, man. Oh hookah God. Wars.
Hookah Wars.
Has anyone died lately, or
Hugh Hefner?
Hugh Hefner, yes, yeah, he's problematic.
He
I never thought about it. He basically turned his house into a brothel.
He did a legal brothel. He got away with it. You know why? GTBW. Mm-hmm. But he died. But he didn't die of like some disease. The nigga was just 190,000 years old.
You know what's wild? He started Playboy by printing Marilyn Monroe's nude photos, which he did not. He wasn't supposed to have. He got access to illegally, and he's being buried next to Marilyn Monroe.
Wow.
And
that's a horror movie plot.
Yeah.
That's a horror movie plot.
Oh my God! Like, yeah. That is a horror movie. If you are in a relationship with somebody right now, just let them know that you bought a plot next to them.
Mm-hmm.
You are just being a little... It doesn't matter if you just met them. Like, if you just met them last week at the bar, just call them and text them right now.
Yep.
And see what their response be like. Yo, I bought this matching funeral plot.
You know how weird that is, though? That's a weird thing, and I had to do that. That's a very weird thing.
I want to sleep next to you forever.
Yeah, it's a creepy thought.
I want to be next to you while worms go in and out my esophagus.
Yeah.
I want our bodies to decompose next to each other.
Yeah, it's creepy.
What happens if, like, the other person dies before you, and now when you get down there, they're, like, and you get, you know, they're, like, already decomposed and shit. Like,
yeah, they got a head start on you and shit.
You're still kind of young.
You looking fly and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Flea, you know what I'm saying? Come
why
down
not?
With your little herringbone shit.
You know what I mean? Why not chalk the shorty over in the next plot that just got buried?
It's not that decomposed and shit. Like, it's like, oh, we're supposed to be buried together. I'm like, yo, ma, your jaw fell off and
come
shit.
On,
you know what I'm
saying? Like, come on,
dude. Look at you, your yeeks is gone. What is that? Fucking, you got beetles back there?
What is that?
This shit.
Is that your pelvic bone exposed? Come on, man. Man, grow up.
Get this. Like, also, I can't even get through the wood and the coffins and shit.
Yo, shout out to everybody that has actually done that, because that is a weird experience,
be buried alive?
Also that, but fucking buying burial plots with your spouse?
Yeah.
That's a weird, it's like, oh, let's plan our death.
I mean,
it's not planning.
I would guess it's smart.
It's smart because you don't want to be planning it when like you're like,
yeah. Oh shit, where they gonna bury this nigga? Just throw him in the garbage.
That's where they get you. They be like, yo. Then they start fucking with. They be like, yo. I mean. We have like a casket, an old casket, you know, for a few cases you really love to. I mean, if you don't, we have like fucking box. Like, this some shit came to the funeral director's office earlier this week. We could just stuff him up and throw him in there, just put him on the curb since apparently that's what you want to do because you're going to love him. I mean, if you want, I could actually physically shit on his body since that's what you're doing by spending this amount of money.
Yo, speaking of that, holy shit. Nigga, I was at Costco the other day. They sell coffins at Costco.
I was about to say that, yeah.
They sell fucking coffins. I'm like, yo, I'm jumping out the coffin if you buy my shit from Costco.
Nah.
I'm duffing you out.
Nah, my pops was there like, yo, pick up three. Come on.
Pick up three.
Just put it in the shopping cart. Push it. He's like, nah. Want to rock through the stash. I'm like,
no.
They're not sneakers.
They're not sneakers. Look at this, a death box.
He went to the house. He opened up. He's got like mad chickens and shit that saved in it. Go in the garage. There's six packs in the coffin.
In the coffin.
I'm like, open the shit. I'm like, what the fuck? The coffin. What kind of knockoff beer is this and shit?
The beer comes out like, hello, you have awakened me.
I'm like, yo, you installed shells in the coffin? That's very. Wow,
I'm impressed.
Yeah, I'm impressed.
How'd you get it to go into like the felt? Fucking cushiony part.
I come down to Florida, shit, and they got the garden hose in it. He's using it as a lazy pool for the house. I like, that's not what he's like. It's my coffin. It's mine. All right,
Dad. How the fuck did you turn a coffin into a lawnmower?
Don't worry about that.
How did you do that?
You bought the compressor from New York. Here.
Yeah, I did. It was in the garbage across the street, like you said. The fucking little guy from Saw is like powering the thing in the back. Like,
do you want to mow a lawn?
Yo.
Goddamn. Oh man. Kind of but yeah, work. Like that's the better way to buy. They need like a coffin of the month club. I don't know.
No, like a wine club?
No,
we'll send you the finest coffins.
We send you a coffin, you got 30 days to try it out.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
If you don't like it,
send it back.
Send it back. We'll clean it and get it to the next nigga.
If you like it, you keep it, we charge it, you just store it. You know how niggas got bikes and shit? You just store it in your house.
All good.
And then when it's time to go, you're like, we have a little wristband, a little that you work around with. And it's like, if I die, don't buy me a new coffin. I'm good. I got a Desus and Mero coffin.
You know what I'm saying?
Shit is branded with our shit.
Like the DNR, like do not change coffin, DNC fucking
C. Do not buy a new coffin. Do not waste money.
DNBC. Damn, coffins at Costco, bro. And they show them like little samples. It's just like a little corner of it so you can see like the detail. Like, oh, that's a nice detail.
Nah, you gotta let me, I need to test drive, baby.
let me lay this shit.
Put me in the bitch and put me underneath the ground.
Yeah.
I'll be like, yo, let's set my iPhone like 1 hour from now.
How terrifying would that be, bro?
Oh my God. How long do you think, like,
how long do you think you would last in a coffin before you lose your shit? Like, yo, get me the fuck out of here.
I'm going to say maybe 45 seconds. Now I'm talking about coffin.
Dirt.
And now I know I physically hear the dirt going on top of me.
Yeah.
No, I will freak. Because you know what? If you are really 6 feet deep, it takes a while to get that dirt out of there.
Yes.
Even if you got air,
and
you like scratch it, like,
and the pressure from the dirt pushes down, and you're losing air.
That's why you have to have a good coffin. Because if you got the cheap IKEA shit,
that's just gonna flatten out. Air's gonna get sucked out.
Put together properly. When you put it together with your girlfriend, she was like, "Why you got extra screws?"
And
when the dirt starts coming out, you start collapsing. You're like, "That's what those screws are for."
Yo,
this coffin.
Get the tape.
Yo.
Get the liquid nail.
Yo, I need a hex wrench. Hurry.
Yo, that's fucking crazy. Man, wow. I thought about that shit and I thought like I could last like 10, 15 minutes.
No.
And then I was like, I seen this movie on Netflix. I was like, starred Ryan Reynolds, where he got kidnapped or whatever and they buried him alive, but he had a cell phone and they were like trying to triangulate his cell phone to try to find him.
Mm-hmm.
And it's one of those movies that you watch and you think like, oh, this is Ryan Reynolds. He's like, you know, Jacobian sweetheart. And you think like the nigga's going to survive and he doesn't. The nigga dies at the end. And there's mad like weird shit that happens. Like he's laying in the coffin. He sees sand start to come in, like, and he starts getting nervous, starts panicking, and the whole shit is set in the coffin, and the nigga, all he has is his cell phone, so he's using that as, like, a light to see, and it's like, yo, that shit really makes a nigga panic, like, you're just watching it, and at one point, a fucking snake comes into the coffin, and he's just, like, and it's just, like, slithering around, and, like, slithering around him and shit, and he's just there, like, and the shit is, like, right on his face, fam. I'm like, who greenlighted this? This is a nightmare, my nigga. Like, I don't remember the name of the movie, but it was like, and then at the end of the movie, you think they found him.
Buried, 2010. Yeah. Cole is a U.S. truck driver working in Iraq, but you ruined it. So yeah. Anyway, yeah.
But
yeah.
Watch it. If you want to have a real life panic attack, immerse yourself in that movie. It doesn't even matter that I told you that because it's just the panic. Yeah.
Yeah. If you want to experience that, waterboard yourself.
Yo.
When you go home, take like a washcloth, put it over your face and your nose and mouth,
yeah.
And pour water on it and try to breathe.
Oh.
That's it's like you need someone else to do it to you, which you should not. Yeah. I mean, like if you have like kids, you could do it. Yeah. But yeah, that's a weird feel. It's like it's similar to sleep paralysis when you're like sleeping and you want to move and you can't move and you can't scream, but you're like,
wow.
You've never had that?
Yeah. Like I'll be in the middle of a dream and want to get out of it and I can't, and then I'll wake up and just be like. You know what I'm saying? Like,
or like you're physically trying to move and yeah, you can't, and yeah. Like, or you can't physically breathe, like, cause you're, listen.
Yeah.
It got dark. We got to do a special Halloween episode.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
We're going to make a special podcast for Halloween. Yeah. They can just play on a loop outside for trick or treaters to scare them. They'd be like,
No, I friends. No fucking candy here.
Nah.
Giuliani. Shout out to the old
Bodegas. Oh, wow. Trump won 2020.
Same time before my ears, you piece of shit.
My bundles are dry.
Niggas only got Reggie on the block.
You gotta have it like, we got no more spicy. Is mild okay? Just have the lady scream like, Urban Halloween sounds.
Yo. Oh my god.
Taylor Swift has knocked Bodak Yellow out of number one.
No! Do you give up candy or are you like fuck you to kids?
Because the thing is it teaches them to become resilient on government handouts and I don't want to create little libertards.
Okay.
Also, if I worked for the candy, why would I give it away for free to other people's kids? Also, Halloween is a Babylon thing. Why are you dressing as monsters walking around? Alright, you want to walk as a real monster?
Yeah.
Walk around as a face of gentrification in this neighborhood.
That's right.
And I come to this town hall to ask you to stop development of 3 family houses and more along East Chester. Thank you.
Everybody's like, okay, sir.
I buy my time to the councilman.
Sir.
Also,
sir,
do you need regulations for the jerk
sir,
truck?
Sir,
why is he allowed to sit there and
sir,
smoke up the
sir,
black all day?
You've had your, sir, you've
asthma.
Had your time, sir.
No,
sir,
no, I
sir,
have another statement.
Sir.
Why sir, is goat meat so bony? Sir, I call for the government to regulate.
Sir, please have a seat, please.
I can't wait till I'm an older Jamaican man. I'm going to waste y'all fucking time.
Sir, we've spoken to the people at Lammy's. They have agreed to debonify the goat a little more. The goat will no longer be as bony. We apologize for the inconvenience. Please just settle down, please. And there's not supposed to be Ray and Nephew at this meeting, sir.
No, I brought my own. I'm not cheering.
Yeah. Yeah.
The floor recognizes more spirits.
Yeah. Oh, man. They're
going to see me walking there. Oh, fuck. Here comes old man Jesus again.
Oh, God. Damn, this nigga's going to come complain.
Saying all his arguing sandals.
Oh, shit. Fuck, man. Now this nigga's going to complain about the fucking chess fucking table we put in the park. God damn, bro.
Ladies, gentlemen, established members of the council.
Oh, God. Here we go.
Reverend.
Here he goes.
Granny.
Oh, my God.
Pastor Russell.
How are you
Mr.
doing?
And Mrs. Corman.
How you doing? How are you?
Antifa. And the alt-right.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to discuss a terror facing the neighborhood. Children are walking upon my lawn, and it is no different than ISIS. They're like, Jesus fucking Christ. Sir, we gotta talk about fire regulations.
You just hear choruses of...
Oh, here we go. Picture it. Bronx, 2017. A retired comedian would just like to sit in his background and read The Gleaner.
Okay.
However,
he said the same story last week.
Radical Islamic Yacoubians.
He said the same thing.
Are coming around with gluten.
How do we get him out of here?
This guy's gonna be 3 people in the council meeting. It's gonna be me and the council members. I'd be like,
fuck, bro. Slick Rick comes through like, yo, what's going on?
A little story.
Lottie Dottie, you need to fucking get the fuck up out of here before I catch a body.
Oh, shit.
Shout out to Slick Rick B, hip hop legend.
He almost did catch a body. Remember he went to jail?
Yeah.
Yeah, niggas think Slick Rick is soft. People who think it's just a wash song you hear at a party, you're like, damn.
Nah, niggas hear Mona Lisa, thinks he's soft? Nah.
Everyone's like, damn, this song is mad washed.
Mm-hmm.
That's a watch on Poison.
Wasn't it his cousin? He shot his cousin or somebody tried to rob him or some shit?
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? He had hired his first cousin as bodyguard. Mm. His bodyguard tried to extort him. And he was like, yeah. I'm not with the shits.
Extort this dick,
man. Service package. He tried to rob him on numerous occasions, threatened to kill the rapper and his mother. When Slick Rick found bullets in... He found bullets in his front door. He bought guns, like, nah, fuck this. Mm-hmm. And he spotted him in the street, like a couple blocks away from me, and was like, pop, 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 pop.
Hold that.
He didn't catch him, but he had to go to jail for attempted murder and other charges. 5 years.
Damn, what a scumbag.
But that guy that he tried to kill, let me not slander him, just make everyone claro about this.
Did he end up getting smoked?
I believe he got killed because he, like... Something. I forgot what happened to him.
He tried to extort another wrong person?
He tried to... not extort. I don't want to, you know, get sued because we got to be low now.
Allegedly. This is all alleged.
It's all alleged. Well, this is from the Wikipedia page.
This is all hearsay.
Because the ending of the story is pretty gnarly.
Oh, shit. When you say that, I'm like, oh shit, what the fuck happened?
I think he went to jail for like underage time or something. Like a guy that his cousin, some shit like that.
Oh, so good for you fucking piece of shit.
If it's true, I don't know if it's true or not. So okay. Sorry about that. I killed the energy of the podcast. I'm sorry, y'all. See, that's what happens. You try to study facts. You try to be careful what you say because you don't want to get sued. Yeah. And you know what? I'm sorry, y'all. What more you want for free?
Come on, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Give you the podcast free, nigga, everything.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? You got the law. It's episode 82, baby.
You know what I'm saying?
We gave you our all. We died out here in the streets, you know what I'm saying?
Left it all on the court.
Okay, I hope y'all wasn't kneeling during our podcast.
You know what I mean?
That would be wrong.
It's wrong. My soul.
Shout out to the sponsor. Yeah. Shout out to Rebel Studio. Shout out to Squarecash. Shout out to Bodega Dream Store in the building. Listen, Toronto, we come for you. Yes. This weekend, you're going to see us.
That's right. Wheel up.
You're going to love us.
Wagwan.
It's going to be wonderful.
Yes.
We got some jokes on there. We don't got jokes. We're just going to take jokes from like early episodes, just string it together. Not going to really make jokes.
Yeah.
Not going to make sense.
Yeah, it don't matter.
Fuck it. We're phoning it in now. We've done enough shows now. We don't have to prove anything.
Yeah, we just go out there fucking spit water on stage and wild out.
Let's go out there like Toronto. You're lucky you get to see our faces.
You know what I'm saying?
You might
just sit there crisscross applesauce and meditate.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Might sage the stage. T-Dot, we're going to definitely bring out Drake, though, so make sure you're there.
Yeah.
We're bringing out the OVO Owl.
We said we're going to bring out Drake, bring out Tory Lanez.
We're going to bring out Drake from Drake and Josh.
Got it.
I'll be like, you didn't say with Drake.
Stupid.
How you feel?
We bought Darkwing Duck out, stupid. Ha ha.
Darkwing Duck. When there's trouble, you call DW.
DW. Is that the launchpad for being
what was multiple launchpad? What was launchpad's career trajectory? Because he was, wasn't he like...
He was the helicopter guy in DuckTales.
Well, he was popping on DuckTales. Like, he was flying the PJ. But was he washed during Darkwing Duck? Was he, like, unemployed now?
Yeah.
He just hanging with that nigga?
He was just like a goofball.
He just, like, Darkwing Duck.
Like, hey, Darkwing Duck.
Niggas sit in his apartment, like, fucking... mad drunk talking about I used to fly fucking.
I used to fucking
used to drive around Scrooge McDuck fucking launch. My name is launch fucking
pad fucking McQuack. Don't you fucking forget it. All right, you piece of shit.
Nigga slamming on bottles like you fucking stand for an anthem.
You fucking stand.
You Suzette music. You stand up. Yeah? You piece of shit.
You fucking pieces of garbage. Let me tell you something.
There's a character called Colin. Quackernick. He's not standing for the anthem.
You Quackernick, you
Quacker
fucking
Nick,
stand
you
up.
You fucking nigger.
You fucking Quacker fucking niggers,
you
more like it.
Our anthem. Blue died for the flag, man.
You fucking asshole. Oh. Hey, you know what? Fuck Monterey Jack. He's a foreigner. He doesn't belong here.
Home.
Go back to your fucking country, Speedy
fucking
Gonzalez.
Rangers are taking our jobs.
Fuck you.
Launchpad definitely voted for Trump.
Oh, yeah.
He got the MAGA hat and shit. He's talking to Darkwing Duck like, you know, radical Islamic terrorism.
Yeah.
That's why we have the guns protected from the air pirates.
That's right. You fucking asshole.
Why don't they ever say anything? I talked to the lady that does the Tailspin delivery service. You know, she's paying an enormous tax rate. We're going to get the tax rate Trump promised us.
We got to bring it down. My helicopter runs on coal.
Donald Trump is like a big bear with like a comb over and shit. I promise you, I'll protect Cape Suzette.
I'll protect all of you.
Listen, there's a lot of single mothers out here.
Yo.
These are entrepreneurs of the life business. How long have you waited to get your airplane fixed?
How long must you wait? Listen to me.
Yo, Gidget, meet me in the green room in the back later. All right,
get some Monterey Jack and my cheese. You know what I'm saying? I'm not talking about that fat guy.
Where the fuck was Monterey Jack from? Was he Australian?
Probably Monterey. I don't know.
Monterey.
I mean, a lot. Some of the show made sense, and some of the show didn't.
It made no sense.
Why were animals like repairing shit?
What was the wackest cartoon to you of that whole block?
Gummy bears.
Gummy bears.
Gummy bears. I was like, what's the fucking point of this shit? They just bouncing.
They drink lean and they bounce. Like, get the fuck out of here. Like, yo.
We gotta reboot Gummy Bears and just have the really. It's just gonna be like dope fiends.
They're just drinking that mad high tech and shit. Like, yo.
They've gone off the K2 and shit.
Niggas spinning the Sprite bottle around and shit, mixing it up.
Lean. Like, what was that? I don't even know. I don't know any of the characters. I don't know none of the plot lines. I think it's because that show came on before I got home from school.
Right. You caught the end of it and you're like, what the fuck is this bullshit? This shit out here.
Don't we eat gummy bears?
Like, fuck is this dumb shit?
I was like, nobody care about
niggas
this.
Niggas have
fucking
no fucking spin offs.
I was like, show the black one with the black guy flying the plane.
Yeah, that's like, my
blue.
Shit.
They're like, blue's not black. I was like, fuck up.
So fuck up. He's a black bear. You stupid.
Black. All the gargoyles are black.
Fuck out of here. Feel? Stupid.
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles are black too.
Yeah, and Kit is Puerto Rican. Because he had the hoverboard early.
Yeah. They got the scammer board?
They had the scammer board before anybody.
Oh, man.
Fuck out of here.
Yo. Oh, yo. Lord. Yo. Anyway, shout out to all the sponsors. It's been episode 82. You know what I'm
That's
saying?
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Real gangster food edition. Nah, here.
You know what I mean?
Boy, Jesus Nice, aka Jesus Vice, aka Young Chipotle. Poxy Fat Material, Christopher Slim Dick, Eli Libby, Boots really good. Somebody that might
That's
know you.
Right.
Young Day Party, Young Hot Take, Tuesday Fuego, Mr. Nanos Rolando, Mio Novas at the Nevada, Quattro, Mikhail going off, the Juve Boss,
That's
MC,
right.
Nickel Goofy, put up for 40 with your shorty, aka Don't Talk to Me in the Uber Pool.
I don't fucking know you, nigga.
The original my plus one got a fuss one, so don't make a fuss, son. As a matter of fact, I don't even got plus ones now. Now we just coming gooned out.
Yeah.
I'm coming dead 10
yeah,
deep.
Nigga. I got plus 12, nigga, and I don't care if it's on the list.
When you how many you roll away? I'm like, all of them.
Them.
Even the two white people that them. Just joined at the end of us, I don't
yeah,
even know them.
I don't care.
Like, yo, he got too many people in his crew. I'm just going to join in because he won't see us at the end of it.
Yeah.
Jermaine Avocado, too.
Yeah.
Smash some fucking avocado on your fucking toast and change your day, you piece of garbage.
Yeah.
Young Pa, to go some Mufasa. Young Chakunery without the coonery.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? AKA Chili Lamar. Left-handed reliever for the Yankees. K-O-K, yeah. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't matter. World Scout, World Wild Card, if that's how you get in,
Papi,
that's how you get in.
We get in.
Okay.
But it don't matter because we fucking dominate.
Dominate every day, every day.
That's right. Every game.
Mike K, Masu, Zaka, Trifone Jones, DJ Chuckles, DJ Machina, J Chuckles, Stanley Cups, Demon Dr. Bonner's label, Dilute, Dino De Trapio, Mr. 240p, because I like my Pinot blurry, and I hope it loads faster. I don't really need that 4K stuff.
Uh-huh.
I don't want to see any warts near your anal.
Nah,
DJ Warlike, aka you're listening to Wash FM. Up next, we got 4 hours of Ruben Studdard, which just means I'm playing Sorry for 2004 10
uh-huh,
times.
That's right.
The Curry Goat, DJ Spy, Icer, Jamal Hashburn, the Bronx, Celine Dion, my heart will go on.
Uh-huh.
Nephew to Moreno, you cannot contain. Oh, I'm like spilling mercury. Try to do that. You ever try to? You ever spill
they
mercury?
Can't, you can't.
To
this goes
you
everywhere.
Put a magnet behind paper towel.
Ooh.
Okay. That's just if you go in your DT's
knowledge.
Purse and she drops a little vial of mercury she got at the botanical. She carries her off for good luck. That's neither here nor there. That's some Bronx shit. The human Mary. What's a jaw? Young Aaron, the racist provocateur. Henrik Budquist, Nelson Mandela. Sarah Gio, can't
that's
see
right.
me. Don't care. You got 20/20 vision.
Uh-huh.
Can't see me. I'm out your scope of vision. Vladimir Buffin. The human weather's melting Ooh. In your mouth. Mr. Bexon Deckington, Ricky Tiki, Squabby, Greg Popovich, Marcel Itrichesna, Marhutna, Gun Bill.
Yeah.
Not Mahatma B, but I got that cucumber.
Uh huh.
He's got the big head. Yeah. The juice is unpressed, but your boy never is.
Never.
And when they came and they asked,
yes.
They said, who amongst you is the art?
Yes.
And I stood and I said, I am the art.
Yes.
And they said, who is the art? And Mero stood and said, I am the art. And we all stood together and said, I am the Lord,
oh,
damn it!
Damn it!
I am Spartacus! Donna Kanush, no more coming noodles, the Prince of Peckham, the Fast Nova Casanova,
that's
William
right.
8 cent, 5 cent, 10 cent, dollar! Forget the small change, give me big money. Line.
Big money.
The only
line.
Anthem I salute is Dipset.
Uh huh. Mm-hmm. Dipset, Dipset.
Mr. Chopping that street easy with bad reasons like I'm easy, please believe me. The black Asian crack your back like an automatic Whoop. Craft mag. Mr. Lamarina, Mesmerina, with a fresh misdemeanor, and a cold demeanor, aka your problematic bae.
Mwah, yeah, bitch. You know what I'm saying? That's been episode 82.
82.
Of the illustrious art. You're fucking welcome.
You know what I'm saying? You know who it is. You know what I'm saying? Your boy, the Kid Mero, a.k.a. the Human Direct Flap, a.k.a. Donovan McDab, a.k.a. Curve Gotti, a.k.a. Triz Khalifa, a.k.a. Skirt Loader, a.k.a. James St. Fatic. I'll ghost on you, shorty, and I'll kill Kanan. I'll do it. A.k.a. I know fucking baby, I fucking man. You see my hookah store, my nigga, and look at my dad.
Look at it.
You know what I'm saying? Check the guest list again, you fucking dickhead. You fucking piece of shit. I'll have you fired. You'll never work in this fucking town again. I got... nigga, I'm standing here with Desus and Vashti and Paris Hilton. Paris Hilton ain't even wearing panties, nigga. You think I'm frightened about who I am? I'm getting in here.
Open the door.
Open the fucking door.
Open the door.
You know what I'm saying?
Don't get... Listen, you're gonna look... You're gonna look stupid.
Come
right here.
Come here, let me tell you something.
Yo, that's Kid Mero. Like, you gonna get fired. You don't let me sing it.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, I know you think... Like, he, I know he's in a steam tech suit and this is like a pavilion, but yeah, like... Let the nigga in. I'm just saying, if you know smart.
You know the thing? Like, should I do it? You cool. Take it. I'll roof your fucking kids' ball, fuck your kids' ball, to impress my kids, because it's the fucking dad of the year, a.k.a. Ben Smack Biombo, a.k.a. Field the Ass Tyson, a.k.a. Frying El Messi, MVP of La Mota, a.k.a. Tom Brady. I'm a positive guy. You're sure you got my balls kind of deflated, but you know what I'm saying? I'm holding in. I'm hanging in tight. MAGA forever. A.k.a. the Dominican Dada, a.k.a. Barlo Santana. Hit that guitar solo. A.K.A. Dick in your Bay Matumbo. You do not come into this pussy no more. This pussy belongs to me and only me. Stay out of the paint, motherfucker. A.K.A. Ben Boss and my hands are gifted. I'll perform your vasectomy on the 4 train using only a churro I purchased at 34th Street. You're welcome. A.K.A. Lightning Touchy. Hello? Is it weed you're looking for? I can see it in your eyes. That you're broken, so you got five.
You don't even got five.
You don't even got five, dog. Nigga, it's 2017,
like
nigga.
You live like this?
Come on, dog. At least come out with a fucking Andrew.
The fuck you,
you know what I'm saying?
Nigga,
fuck out of here.
Pulls on the Dutch. You don't even got five,
son.
Nigga.
And you know what to do if you're throwing a dinner party, a housewarming party. Lock your fucking medicine cabinet, nigga, because it's the fucking Zen, man. I hope I don't open your shit.
Honey, have you seen my pills? Mero was in the bathroom and now they're missing.
Yeah. Nigga, so you better leave everything out of there except the centrum, nigga, because I'm not interested in that. Mm. You know what I'm saying? A.K.A. Rico Sabroso, A.K.A. Baby Newport, A.K.A. Zaniel Bedingfield. Now you gotta get some sticks. Now you gotta get some sticks. A.K.A. Neo Brown, A.K.A. East Tree My Stevie B. I wanna be the one your D.D. is fucking. Up next, we got T.K.A. A.K.A. from across the pond, mate. The plantain supernova in the sky. One day you will find me smoking weed on Tremont. Smoking 99 cent wraps because I'm broke. Dog, I say this every week, and every week you approach me like I am not an ursine mammal. So I beg of you, if you see me in Target in the dollar section, putting things in the front of my jeans, approach me like an ursine mammal, dog, because I will claw your head off like you are Leonardo DiCaprio and I'm the bear in the revenant. Mm. Okay? You know what I'm saying? Hasan, dime la pita. ¿Qué fue? Llegó la estrella de cine. No te cruces que te dejo de cocotao. Pásame 20 o te rompo los dientes. Mamá huevo. Sasasasasasaso. Tírame por WhatsApp y mándame nota, mami. Si tú no sabes escribir, ratrera. We out. Episode 22. Make it dead. Yeah. That was great.
Episode 82. We out of this bitch.
Yo, I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Squarecast. Shout out to the sponsor. Oh. Shout out to Red Bull. Allowing us to make the crystal clear clarity.
That's
that
right.
Is the art. Toronto, if you see us having trouble at the airport, tell the customs agent, let them in. We're
yo,
good money.
Tell them we know Mike Myers.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying?
Do.
We
okay.
do. We know money. Mike Myers.
Nah, matter of fact, one fucking problem at the board. I'm making one phone call to Shane. He'll
yo.
Air this whole shit out.
He'll air this shit the fuck out.
The big homie
I dare you.
Don't make it. Listen. Don't make it tight. And don't check our bags when we're coming back. When we might be coming back with that loud Pacquiao.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
You know what I'm saying?
We ain't talking about that Pauline.
Shout out to Red Bull, though. Real quick, wanted to say, we're out of the orange.
Mm-hmm.
I was a little sad. But the red, shout out to all my Dominicans, tastes like Country Clue.
Ooh.
The shit is delicious.
Ooh.
So shout out to Red Bull for coming out with flavors that I actually enjoy.
He doesn't drink now. He makes money moves.
You know what I'm
hey.
Saying?
Hey. Episode 82. Bodega Boys in the building.
That's right.
Check us out on a many, 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 many different platforms.
Everything.
That we're on.
Everything. The live shows.
Live
Neo
shows.
Yokio. Desus and Mero. Fucking literally everything.
Yeah, everything.
We're out here.
After this, we're going to be on 34. She's talking about white people and saying how they were created by Yakub. So please join us.
Did you bring a wrestling belt?
Oh, you know I did.
It's lit.
We out.
Holla.